We started this thing, and now we're on top. Everybody's trying to knock us off. It's us versus them. We must protect this house. Will you protect this house?
I will.
We must protect this house.
The shop is open.
Claims of or resignation.
Hello, Georgia.
In a Saturday phone call, President Trump urged Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger to overturn the state's November election results.
All I want to do is this. I just want to find 11,780 votes, which is one more than we have, because we won the state, and flipping the state is a great testament to our country.
Raffensperger and his general counsel pushed back on the unfounded claims.
Well, Mr. President, the challenge that you have is the data you have is wrong.
But President Trump continued to double down.
There's no way we lost Georgia. There's no way. That was a rigged election, but we're still fighting it, and you'll see what's going to happen. We'll talk about it.
At a Monday rally ahead of Georgia's Senate runoff elections, the president repeated the unfounded allegations and said that Vice President Mike Pence had the power to reject Electoral College votes at a joint session of Congress later that week.
I hope that our great vice president comes through for us. He's a great guy. Of course, if he doesn't come through, I won't like him quite as much.
The pressure play put the vice president in the spotlight, even though legal experts said he didn't have the authority to reject state results.
Look, the future of the country is on the ballot here in Georgia today.
Georgia voters have never had more power than you have today.
On Tuesday, as Georgia voters went to the polls to decide which party would control the Senate, the president tweeted and retweeted claims of voter fraud, which were flagged by Twitter as disputed.
Democrat Raphael Warnock will unseat Republican Senator Kelly Loeffler.
Democrat John Ossoff will defeat the Republican David Perdue.
And both of those Senate seats are flipping.
This is at the feet of Donald J. Trump. He basically saved Chuck Schumer's chances.
The victories gave Democrats full control of Washington. On Wednesday, President Trump promoted and attended a Save America rally in Washington that took place just before Congress convened to certify President-elect Joe Biden's victory in the November election.
This is Donald Trump's Republican Party.
Let's have trial by combat.
The rally concluded with President Trump encouraging his supporters to march to the Capitol.
We're going to walk down Pennsylvania Avenue. I love Pennsylvania Avenue. And we're going to the Capitol. We're going to try and give our Republicans, the weak ones, because the strong ones don't need any of our help. We're going to try and give them the kind of pride and boldness that they need to take back our country.
In the hours that followed, rioters wearing pro-Trump gear attacked police officers, smashed windows, and broke into the Capitol building, forcing lawmakers to seek cover and temporarily halting the democratic process of certifying the Electoral College votes. Five people, including a Capitol Police officer, died as a result of the unrest. That afternoon, President Trump posted a video on social media.
It was a landslide election, and everyone knows it, especially the other side. But you have to go home now. We have to have peace.
Some social media companies removed the video and later locked the president's accounts, citing violations of their policies.
Criminal behavior will never dominate the United States Congress. This institution is resilient. Our democratic republic is strong. The American people deserve nothing less.
Wednesday night, after the Capitol was clear, Congress reconvened to finish certifying the votes. And back in session, some Republicans who had planned to object to the certification had a change of heart.
The events that have transpired today have forced me to reconsider, and I cannot now in good conscience object to the certification of these electors.
The votes for President of the United States are as follows. Joseph R. Biden Jr. of the state of Delaware has received 306 votes. Donald J. Trump of the state of Florida has received 232 votes.
On Thursday, several government officials resigned. Top Democratic lawmakers called for President Trump's removal, and President-elect Biden blamed President Trump for Wednesday's events, condemning the violence.
What we witnessed yesterday was not dissent. It was not disorder. It was not protest. It was chaos. They weren't protesters. Don't dare call them protesters. They were a riotous mob, insurrectionist, domestic terrorist.
Thursday evening, President Trump posted a new video online addressing the nation.
A new administration will be inaugurated on January 20th. My focus now turns to ensuring a smooth, orderly, and seamless transition of power. This moment calls for healing and reconciliation.
He called the storming of the U.S. Capitol by a mob of his supporters a heinous attack, but accepted no responsibility for the riot. Friday morning, President Trump announced on Twitter that he would not be going to the inauguration of President-elect Biden on January 20th. By the afternoon, Democrats had drafted an article of impeachment that they plan to introduce Monday. The White House pushed back against the effort and in a statement said, a politically motivated impeachment against a president with 12 days remaining in his term will only serve to further divide our great country. Friday evening, Twitter said it permanently banned President Trump's Twitter account due to the risk of further incitement of violence. A tweet from President Trump's official U.S. government account said Twitter employees had coordinated with Democrats to try and silence himself and his followers, adding, "We will not be silenced." Twitter removed the tweets from its platform, citing a policy violation. Into the weekend, authorities continued to make arrests and seek information about the perpetrators of Wednesday's riot.
Close to the ground, let's see if you know the bound. Hey yo, y'all standing on dangerous ground. Too close to the bound, let's see if you know the bound. Yo kid, you standing on dangerous ground. Too close to the ground, let's see if you know the bound. Let's embark on this mission like Black Indiana Jones. Eating pookie sandwiches and smoking chronic bones. See, I kill it a little, then leave it alone. Let my man 50G drag it into a zone of his own.
Brands in the room and legion of doom. And if you're saying death squads, the bomb, then I'd assume it. Kick brains, splitting compositions, making decisions, draining the blood about silly niggas like morticians.
Now I'ma Mac out and pimp the rhythm like too short to two down. And wait for wet go around to come around. And beat it in the head with this. Send them off into the unknown, in and out of consciousness. Kinda like a hip hop microphone, hypnotic. Specialist in getting inside the artist. Sick word analyst, world's most fast freestylers. Come on, man, y'all niggas know y'all can't get up with this. And you're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the crown. Let's see if you know the bound. Hey, yo, you're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the crown. Let's see if you know the bound. We said you're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the crown. Let's see if you know the bound. Hey, yo, you're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the crown. Let's see if you know the bound. And killer noise, playboys, cause we have no flaws. We're
Floyd hits, the whole family can enjoy. I'll be mastering the funk like flex, mentally etching and sketching, speaking with my hands like Terminator X. Scheme and get choked out like Radio Raheem. My team will put you to sleep and let you dream. I'm not down with the East West Coast controversy. Me say you, you say me, cross the country making millions. I'll be glad to see a brother get paid for hard work, but instead y'all steady trying to ditch up the dirt.
Yeah, niggas still trying to toss salt in the game, and y'all don't have my name graffitied on the walls of fame. Let me explain, niggas die for fame in this game. My name's like a migraine, rappers get banged out the frame. See some funny style niggas in the house tonight. Imposters too thin to win and too light to fight. Think twice.
You're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the ground. Let's see if you know the bounds. Sure, they're standing on dangerous ground, too close to the ground. Let's see if you know the bounds.
Player, player,
standing on dangerous ground, too close to the ground. Let's see if you know the bounds.
Sure, they're standing on dangerous ground,
too close to the ground. Let's see if you know the bounds.
I had to laugh watching y'all niggas on the corner pumping gas, nervous like you lying to a polygraph. I see a real show, cut off the flow, killing you slow. One time for LO, I'm like a thief in your window.
I'll catch us in the streets, herding like cattle, defeating rappers without contracts and battles, swinging like Mickey Mantle.
Niggas tripping like they wanna be me. Challenge Def Squad, LOD, you living dangerously.
Father! The sleeper has awakened!
What's up, you guys? This is Artisan MC. It's 11:12, a Sunday, and this is Shop Talk Live. Thank you guys for coming through. Sorry, I always forget to switch my mic over while I'm trying to work the screens and shit like that. I'll get it eventually. This is like the third time, so that means the next time I can't fuck it up. If I fuck it up next time, then I'm just not paying attention. So, thank you for coming through. It has been a crazy week, to say the least. Still feeling some kind of way about this week because of the conversations that I've heard, the stuff I've witnessed, and just my own personal shit going on in the background. So I will say thank you guys for contributing early. Thank you to Aquateki, Measly Me, and who was that other person? Sorry. And Arta Ibmore, Doughboy in the building. Thank you guys for supporting the stream. Still need two more people. I don't have 10 yet, but I would like two more people. That's about 50%. So that seems to be standard around these parts. Shout out to Angry Man for setting the standard in the in this sector. What's up? Where'd he go? Double C. What's up, Double C? I sent you an email yesterday, Double C. I pulled some comics for you. Take a look at the picture. Tell me if that's what you like. If you're cool with that, I put an invoice in there too. So if you're cool with that, we can get that taken care of because I got Ford in the shop today and the box is sitting near him so he can stuff it and pack it and all that. Just put your, if you're cool with the selections, just put your shipping information in the email and I'll get that sent out to you this week. What do I want to share? I'll say this. This is the next thing that I actually want to share right now. And let's see if I can get this screen share working correctly. Because this is what this shit made me think of. Let's see. Let's see if that works. Stop that screen. And then we'll play this screen. Nope, that's not working correctly. Okay, let's do this. There's something I want to show you guys, because all this bullcrap that I saw this week, this is what it makes me think of. And this was the point I was trying to get at when I was talking to on an art stream with BGS. I wasn't trying to protect anybody necessarily, but I don't like the overreach from people, because I know crisis in America are always used to steer the herd in a particular direction. And some people use these crises very advantageously to get the shit that they want. And I always err on the side of caution with this shit. So this is what I was thinking about when I saw this. And let me, fuck, I don't know how to do it on just that one screen. Anyway, I'll play this for you guys if you don't know what this is, and we'll just take it from there.
The attendant on my life has left me scarred and deformed, but I assure you, my resolve has never been stronger. In order to ensure the security and continuing stability, the Republic will be reorganized into the First Galactic Empire.
Now, here's the interesting thing about that. That clip cuts out the most important part of that whole scene.
My plan will begin with safety at home, which means...
Right. So this is the piece that they actually left out of that clip I just found. This is the piece that they left out, which is the important piece, because it's what all of this bullshit that I'm seeing around actually shows me. Right. This is what I'm seeing when I hear the rest of this bullshit that's going on with this stuff. All right. Let me just skip ahead a little bit. Okay. Now this is the part that I actually hear.
This is how we get gas. With thunderous applause.
Now, if you have seen any movies in the last decade or so, you understand what's happening in that Palpatine posing as the good and honest senator was behind the scenes. Was behind the scenes manipulating all the events to create this huge civil unrest to grab power for himself. And once he grabbed power for himself, he used the people that were trying to keep him from getting that power as the scapegoats for him to obtain even more power and create the damn empire. And the most poignant scene, the most poignant comment in all of that was Amidala being able to say that this is how liberty dies, by thunderous applause. Now you tell me, in the last, what, 4 or 5 days, what have you seen? What have you seen about all this stuff that's happening now? Does it sound like fucking applause? Sounds like applause to me. Does it sound like you're going to get more policing and all the rest of the shit and people being censored and ferreted out with all this CIA, NSA technology that they was all against like not the day before? Does it sound like that to you? That does it sound like your freedom of speech and your freedom to believe in whoever the fuck you want to is going to now be followed by some Hague-style trials of grabbing these people that were supporters of this one guy and hanging them out to dry? Does it sound like that to you? Now, while I may not like what happened at the Capitol, I think it was fucking ridiculous, but shit happens like that all the time here in this country. I do not believe you should be approving the overreach. Should not. Should not. Torian, you should actually go back and watch the original trilogy, because I can tell you this, Torian, it's a damn sight better than them last three movies you saw. Just saying. And George Lucas was making his own personal commentary in that shit, because mind you, he wrote these scripts. This is his script. These are his words that he wrote about what he was seeing at the time. And at the time he made this movie, we had Walker Bush in office. He had his own ideas. Now, I am not a fan of government gaining more power over people and getting more into their fucking business. I am not a fan of that shit. I'm not. Okay, Toria. I misunderstood. I saw part of your conversation. I misunderstood. But I am not in favor of politicians who work for the people using the power of the government to go after people that they don't agree with. To me, that sounds like tyranny. Now, while I don't think that whole rioting scene was good, was not a good thing, they took that shit a bit too far, I'm not stupid enough. Well, I won't say stupid enough, because I'm not trying to insult anybody. I'm not naive enough to believe that everybody out there wearing a banner and a head wrap and doing some absolutely egregious things in that Capitol was all what they said they were, because they had that shit on. I mean, to me, this is no different than in the summer. You had people, you know, spraying BLM all over the place and busting out windows and stuff, and then finding out they were undercover cops doing that shit. No different. I don't trust everybody just throwing some shit on and saying, yeah, these were all these supporters. No. I don't buy that. The understanding of how a mob works means that it only takes a few agent provocateurs to spark a mob into doing some dumb shit. Don't take a bunch of people. It doesn't have to be the whole group. All you need is 4 or 5 people to push it. You get the sense of the crowd, and you push it. That's it. So do I think the Orange and Chief said some dumb shit? Watching the reports, they all said some dumb shit. But ain't none of them sat there and explicitly told those folks to go and do such and such. Now, the man with the short mustache that everybody wants to equate to automatically, like that's the only motherfucker in history to ever rally a group of people to go after and kill a bunch of other people. I believe he said precisely who he was going after. That's why it wasn't a question. Now, I hold rioters responsible for rioting. There's way too many goddamn cameras all over the place filming these people, which seems too opportune to me. But there's way too many cameras filming these people with no mask on, wanting to be seen, doing some absolutely egregious stuff to say they was all supporters of this one dude. Torian just put up a video this week of one of these goofballs with his whole work ID on. Does he look like a mastermind? Or does he look like a damn sheep? These motherfuckers that you see on camera getting famous for doing some ridiculous stuff like carrying a goddamn Confederate flag through the Capitol. Look, show me who he voted for. Please. Until that time, I'm seeing a dumb motherfucker taking an opportunity to do some dumb shit. That's what I'm seeing. I don't even know how this motherfucker walked through all of Washington with that Confederate flag and nobody took issue with that. It seems too contrived to me. It seems too fucking contrived. I'm not defending shit. And Silent Lamont, I know you go on everybody panels talking shit to people about this stuff. I don't want to hear that shit here, dude. I don't even know how you found me for that shit. So if you got something to say about that shit, I know you got a channel and you've been around a long time. Go say that shit there. This is not the channel for that. I'm speaking my piece on my channel. Now, you can calm that shit down or you can come over here and talk about some geek shit or something like that, but you can drop all that political shit at the door. I do not talk politics over here. I'm speaking my piece on this shit. Because I've seen way too many panels with motherfuckers yelling over each other about dumb shit that is only going to affect us, good or bad. And I can agree with you there. There's no universe where black folks will get this many excuses. They don't. Me and my daughter was talking about it the day it happened. And my daughter is a little bit more activist than I am. She was saying the same shit at 21. You wouldn't have got all those excuses. Anybody black in here already knows that. That shit don't even need to be said. Anybody black watching that shit already know when you was watching it, like, we would have got killed. We would have got fucking killed. It's not a surprise. It's not a shock. What I'm saying, I hold individuals responsible for their actions. The goofy bastard who was taking the barricade and trying to ram it through the doors, grab his ass. That dumb bitch trying to come through the doors, talking all big and bad and got shot. I guess you get what you get. That's Secret Service. That's their job. They was doing their job to protect. You was doing your job to be a dumbass. I think Darwin won in that situation. the rest of these goofy bastards who was all through people's offices and shit like that. Look, I'm still in a state of mind. All that shit is ours. Even if I don't like these fucking people, those are still fucking citizens. Misguided. Still citizens. I don't work for politicians. Politicians are supposed to be working for me. So I've said it before. I don't give a fuck if they were scared. I don't. There's people out here all over this country scared every goddamn day because they don't know what the fuck is happening. And politicians are sitting up there shitting on them and wasting time and making them suffer. For what? Political points, political power, political theater. That's all I saw this shit as. More fucking political theater. Silent Lamont, you making a whole book in this shit. You writing a whole book in here, and I don't know why. I don't even know why you came here. Exactly, Malika. Dumbass shit, dumbass consequences. If that was me trying to break through the door of the Capitol and Secret Service was on the other side, draw down on me, don't do this, and I ended up dead, wouldn't be a shock to anybody. I'm surprised it was one. But we know, as black men, we know why it was just one of them. Or so few of them. Because white folks. White folks don't want to be killing other white folks like that necessarily, especially not on camera. Silent Lamont, I don't have a problem with you calling things the way you see them. That's all I'm doing. I don't know why you came over here to dispute what I was saying while I'm calling things the way I want to see them on my fucking platform. I really don't. Because this ain't called the opinion space. It's not. It's called Shop Talk Live for a reason. I'm talking shop live. Not unsolicited opinions on it. Because I've listened to everybody else's unsolicited opinions, and you've been on plenty of other panels talking, I'm sure. So I probably heard your opinion already. Silent Lamont, I don't have a big enough channel to have sycophants. I don't. Well, that's where you're wrong, because if you go to my channel and look at my thing, look at my intro, it'll tell you what this channel is about. It is. And because as the host of this panel, I'm talking about what's going on with what I saw, my perspective on what I saw, my opinion is not up for necessarily debate, necessarily. We can debate on what happened, but I'm not debating my fucking opinion. My opinion is my fucking opinion. There is no debate on that shit. Now, if you want to come here and troll my fucking chat room with all the stuff you got to say, I think that makes great content for your channel. You should be saying that shit over there. You should. That's why you have a channel. If you want to argue with people about this shit, then you go on people that have panels and do that shit. That's not what I do over here. I don't even necessarily argue about geek stuff unless it's me and Arta Idmore and Charles. And that's just because we geeks and those are my boys. We can have that conversation. I don't know you like that. Don't. You don't know me like that. And just like I wouldn't come to your house and start trying to disrespect you, you are way out of line coming in my space trying to disrespect me like that. That's what your channel is for, your opinion. So you got one more comment to make, and then I'm going to, in the words of the master teacher, bid you adieu. Because I don't have sycophants because I'm not the leader of anything. I don't have a big enough channel to be a leader of anything. The people who are over here because they want to hear a conversation. They want to be part of a conversation without insulting the other people or the host. I don't do that shit. Feelings. Look, I'm hearing the same tropes from you every time I hear you on somebody's panel, Silent. I'm hearing the same tropes. You got one more comment. It better be one sentence or else I will time you out. You can watch from the cloud or something. Because my sun is not rising and setting on your opinion. But I don't like you insulting the rest of the people that are here to listen who actually support my channel. So if you got this much to say, drop $20 in my fucking Cash App and then we can have that conversation. Because right now you're wasting my damn time. Just for everybody else listening, I apologize for that derailing the show a little bit, but I will tell you that I won't call them panel prostitutes because a panel prostitute to me is a female. But these motherfuckers who have nothing to do all day but jump on other people's panels and talk shit in their chat room and talk shit on their panels and stuff like that, like they making a name for themselves. I believe people need to be charging people to get on fucking panels from now on. You do. You need to have a fucking $10 cover to get on somebody's fucking panel and fucking talk. You should. And it still don't mean you get to say whatever the fuck you want to. Because trust and believe, like a exclusive fucking club, you have to pay to get in the door. Bouncer has to think you ain't going to be a problem to let you through the door. Once you get in, there are still rules inside of that fucking club. Don't mean that just because you paid your cover at the your door charge, you can get on top of the table and start acting a goddamn fool and drinks are free. Oh, no, motherfucker. All this shit costs. And if you coming in here to have a fucking problem, an issue, you need to stay your ass outside on the other side of that rope. Because you ain't here for nothing but bullshit. Nothing but bullshit. Who asked for all that shit? Who know this motherfucker that he found my fucking channel to show up? I don't talk about shit he says and it's the first time he's ever showed up over here. How? Now, mind you, everywhere I go and the people I listen to, I've seen this motherfucker many a times. Over the last year, too many times, because I don't like being irritated. But here he pop up in the little geek section because what? Because I said something about some fucking riots? Get the fuck out of here. I have time for that shit. I don't have anything against the brother. Aside for the fact that you do this on everybody's channel and it's really disrespectful. And I'm not a fan of disrespectful people. Black, white, male, female, child, I don't give a fuck. I'm not a fan of disrespectful people. Because that's a choice. You're choosing to disrespect people. And what I know from people who do that so blatantly, it's a weak person's imitation of strength. You do not have to disrespect people to get your fucking point across. You do not have to come in here, insult me, insult my audience to try to, oh, I just want to get my opinion out. I thought this was the place for intelligent brothers. All that condescension, female, passive aggressive bullshit is just what that is. You got a whole fucking channel. You put that shit up on your channel, maybe I'll watch and listen to what you have to say. Don't bring that shit to my fucking channel. I don't want to hear that shit. Don't. That's why you have a channel. If I want to hear it, I'll go over there and find it. I won't, though. Double C. Yeah, it must be a slow Sunday. You must have heard through the grapevine there was a panel. Or that I do panels. No, I don't. And he got longer. He should actually be happy. He got longer than Jessica Lightass did. She got one comment in a block. Snipe on site. I've heard enough of her shit on any other people's channels. Don't bring that shit here. Stay safe in the clouds. Don't come down here on Earth. You pick people off down here. Sorry. That shit, he got a whole spiel just so I could see what the fuck he was actually trying to say. Anyway, look. To get back on with my point, because this has been the main thing that's been happening on YouTube and in this space, and people can't have a civil discussion about this shit and express any idea that doesn't say the white folks is wrong for doing it and you should be behind all of this shit and it's all Trump's fault. I don't give a fuck whose fault it is. It's the people that was out there rioting's fucking fault. I'm a grown goddamn man. Ain't nobody gonna cite me to do shit. Not shit. I don't give a fuck what you say. Maybe that's just the benefit of being black or growing up in California or having the I don't give a fuck gene or having a little bit of sense of rebellion in me that I don't follow whatever the fuck somebody else says. But I do not like people using events to push their bullshit. I don't. And I always am always skeptical about government doing it. Always. I don't care who sits in a goddamn seat. I'm skeptical of any of this overreach that they try to do when there's an event. Because you know, that's how propaganda works. It's always some big ass event. So they can try to pull a little bit more of your rights from you. And you never really know who behind all this bullshit. You never really know. I would tell you the people who really behind it is the seats that don't change. The seats that don't change. It ain't a secret. Nobody, not a lot of people in government like the Orange in Chief. That ain't a fucking secret. I don't really like his ass. I just think people got what they fucking paid for. They did. If you had a better candidate on the other side, he would have never got elected. Blame yourself. Was there some hanky shit going on this last time? Yeah. Were they able to prove it? Not that I know of, but everybody was in on it. So why would they want to prove it? Nobody likes them. Why would they help them? That's like a black dude trying to get justice in court. Or that cat that Dr. Tiasan was talking about just this week. He got out of jail after, what, 30-something goddamn years? Or, excuse me, 29 years? Just now getting out of jail. Oh, he wasn't the one who did it. We got to pay him $9.8 million. Oh, really? Do you think he had somebody fighting in his corner to prove that he was not the one at the time? Or was everybody on code with saying, no, we don't like his ass, he going to jail? Prison for life. Come on, man. As black people, we can't be jumping behind everybody's fucking banners just because we don't like the person that they hating. Fuck these people. Behind every great crime, there is somebody who gains. Who has gained the most from this debacle-less bullshit? Who gained the most? Don't think it was that the Republican Party. Don't. I think it was another party. Some of the other reports are saying that they were saying some of these folks that was on the camera out there in front with all this wild shit was parts of other fucking groups that was in these other riots and shit. Oh, really? We gonna discount that kind of proof? Just for what we want, though. Don't fall for the banana in the tailpipe and don't listen to the motherfucker waving a red flag at you because he got a sword behind it. Come on, man. All these motherfuckers is crooked. Stop choosing sides with these motherfuckers. Stop picking sides against your folks to side with these people. Doing the same shit the black female was doing. Come on, man. I've been saying this shit since Obama got out the office. These motherfuckers have been sitting on their hatred for 8 years and having to hold it in and cover their mouth and act like they was okay with this shit. They was not okay with this shit. It was going to come out. It was going to come out. Is that why you got him? Yeah, probably so. But you also got it because nobody wanted to stand behind that chick. Nobody wanted to stand behind her. They didn't like her either. Because she's a symbol for the rest of the bullshit that we've been dealing with in this manosphere section. And for the last, what, 30, 40 years. She could have been the poster child for that shit. So all those people who felt disaffected and scared of their own genetic annihilation, in a sense, you don't think they're going to be pissed off? Somebody could have spoke to them. Somebody could have. Just like when us as black people get pissed off enough, somebody going to have to speak to us. So look, this may seem all convoluted because I don't like getting into all this political shit. I don't. That's why I just give my opinion and leave it. I'm not looking at one of them as a white knight and I'm not looking at one of them as the devil. I'm not. I don't do that, you know, pluralistic duality bullshit with these politicians, dude. They will do whatever they need to gain power. Whatever they need to. And if it means that somebody up the chain have people stand down, don't have enough officers on the beat that day, oh my God, fall back the lines and let these motherfuckers storm the goddamn Capitol. Yeah, the responsibility falls on the highest official. It does. The responsibility for the failure falls on the highest person. But I know there's a police chief. I know there's somebody over him. I know there's somebody over that person. And they have calls and responsibilities that they have to do. Common sense type of shit. I live here in California. I've been seeing a batter every day since the election was over about Stop the Steal, going towards affluent white areas that I'm driving through to get back to my home. They had it posted up on the overpass, Stop the Steal. And you know what I heard every time I was driving through there? People honking for that shit. Because that's what the populace believe. They all watch the goddamn election. They have their own opinions. You don't have to agree with that shit. They can be wrong all goddamn day, but that's the beauty of free fucking speech. You get to be wrong and they look at your ass and tell you, yeah, you are wrong, but whatever the fuck. And you can look back at me and say, well, I think you're wrong. Well, that's your choice too. One thing is going to prove who's right or wrong. Time. Time is going to tell you who is right and who is wrong. These motherfuckers rushing so quick for that impeachment within the last 12 days, that tells me, don't sound right. Don't sound right. All this shit with the blocking of the Twitter and all that shit, don't sound right. I watched them Senate hearings with YouTube, Twitter, Facebook. I watched those Senate hearings. What's up, Master Teacher? Up to a point. Yeah, I can agree up to a point. Was the point breached? I don't support a fucking riot. I told you guys that. I got one of my videos banned recently, or got blocked recently. The video was from the summer. talking about the riots then, and all of a sudden it got blocked. Like, who going back through, like, what are we on, 46 right now? Somebody went back over 30 goddamn videos to find that one and block that one? Get the fuck out of here. Nobody reading my catalog, watching my catalog like that. That is subversion. That's subversion stomping out dissent. You can't even say certain shit on these platforms now about stuff that you actually fucking witnessed. That's 1984 time. That's what that shit is. You can't say certain things? I guess the Ministry of Love is in effect now. And BGS, here's the thing with the mule. And this is why I don't equate the Orange in Chief to the mule. Told you, that's a disrespect to the mule. I have more sympathy for the mule than I have for the Orange in Chief. I have no sympathy for the Orange in Chief. He do dumb shit. Well, that's to be expected. That's why I just throw up my hands when motherfuckers say, he did something else crazy. I'm like, what did you expect? What the fuck? What did you expect? Right? Yeah, Aquateki, the algorithm is in full effect. And what is the fucking algorithm? Algorithm is what, thinking and predicting? And basically a band. It is a traveling, not a band, but a gag. The algorithm is used as a gag and a silencing device to keep the opinions that they don't want circulating from circulating. That's not okay. That is not an okay thing. I don't know how people don't get that shit. Like I've told you guys before, I don't care about a person having a dissenting opinion against something I'm saying because I want them to throw their flag up so I know where the hell they at. So I can see them. I don't need them underground. I need them out in the open where I can deal with their ass. I'm in, you know, behind the scenes California where everybody's smiling your face and behind your back they talking and plotting about ways to fuck you over. So I don't like these motherfuckers being able to hide, have their voices stifled. Well, throw that shit up there. Let me see it. I'm a grown up. I can see that shit. Because I need it for an object lesson to show my kids what they need to be looking for. And I need it so I know who I need to be pointing my shit at. Well, like, yeah, these motherfuckers over here on some bullshit, but I know they there. As long as I know they there, we ain't got no problem. It's like that spider in the corner of your room. As long as that motherfucker stay right there, we ain't got no problems. If you bring his ass over here, problems all day. Problems all day. Nah, BGS, I'm not for that impeachment bullshit. I'm not for that. That's like a Democrat's wet dream right now. They've been wanting to impeach that motherfucker from day one after he got inaugurated. Look, man, fuck them with that. I'm not giving them no easy fucking wins on this shit. Fuck them with that shit. They wasted more time in the last 4 years doing this ridiculous dumb shit than they have taking care of the people's business. They $600 check giving asses. All these people out here out of work and shit like that. And y'all dicking around just so you can turn around and give them $600. Thanks for your trouble. Fuck off. Fuck that impeachment shit. Let him spend his last 12 days and go out in shame and call it a day. Because they were going to have to do, in my mind, they were going to have to do something to smear him more before he left. They don't want him coming back. And like I told you, BGS, I want to see him try to run again. Don't bar him from running again. Let him run again and exhaust that shit and see where these fucking people are. He ain't going to win again. There is no way in hell he can win again. Not after this shit. Mm-mm. This shit is being hung around his neck like a clock on Flavor Flav. He ain't never getting rid of this stink. Never. 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 He ain't never getting rid of this stink. This gonna follow him past the grave. Into the history books. I'm fucking cleaning my ears. I had to realize what I was doing. I can't hear. I just got out the shower, y'all. That's why. He should be on trial for sedition and treason. I don't know about that, Master Teacher. I mean, you know I have a lot of respect for you. We can disagree. We can disagree on that. Look, just let that motherfucker go about his business. And one day, you know, sometime in the future, get on some Bob Lee swagger bullshit and somebody just show up. And if they feel that strongly about it, then they handle that shit that way. If y'all don't know who Bob Lee Swagger is, go read a goddamn book. That's what this channel is about. Read, motherfucker. Do you do it? Fuck. I'm just not into all the emotion of the shit. I'm just not. I'm not into arguing with brothers about this shit because one way or the other, if you find out all this shit was orchestrated 10 years from now, you'll feel like a fool. You will. If you find out it wasn't all orchestrated 10 years from now, you'll probably still feel like a fucking fool. It doesn't matter. The thing that matters to me is how this shit affects black folks. How it affects black folks. I don't give a fuck about these white folks and what they do. They're running this goddamn country. If they're going to run it into the ground, let them run it into the goddamn ground. Fuck them. I'm trying to survive and make sure when they run it to the ground, at least me and mines will get to some kind of fucking safety. Or they blow the whole goddamn building up on themselves. That's what I care about. And for me, I want black folks, at least on one accord, with thinking about how this affects black people before whose party was right and whose party was wrong. Fuck them parties. Fuck them with their bullshit. You didn't design that shit. Why do you fucking care? They ain't been operating in the greatest benefit for you anyway. They're not. So why do you care? Why be invested like that? Can't see it. So I guess in a George Carlin kind of way, I'm here for the fucking mayhem in a sense, I guess. Let them do what they're going to do. This whole shit is breaking down anyway. This is another sign of the fucking breakdown. Let it break the fuck down then. That's what's going to happen. But like I said, just from watching this shit, you're standing on dangerous ground. This is dangerous ground to fucking be on. Because if this shit would have just happened in-house and nobody had seen it within the U.S., that would have been one thing. Whole fucking world saw this shit. Because at this point, when it gets outside of these shores, there is no separating us from those Trump supporters and these people over here and this. There is none of that from people looking from the outside at us. We are all the fucking same. And what that showed was a bunch of goddamn weakness. House in order, or house in disorder, in disarray. That's what that fucking shows. Now, you can beef up security all fucking day long. You think this would be the last time you see that shit? I'm under understanding, maybe it's just because of working in construction, but I understand that anything designed by man will be imperfect and has a flaw in it. Anything. Systems, buildings, I don't know, security. All that shit has a flaw in it. And all it takes is somebody willing to look the other way. They'll go on and run up these steps. For shit to happen that you never even expected. Don't matter. Like you showed me BGS with that, Lindsey Graham quote. This happened in a post-9/11 world. Yeah, it happened in a post-9/11 world. It's the same way that shit happened. Help. Hell, this is the new 9/11. How did this shit happen? How did it happen? In an election year. I'm curious. But should they be grabbing these people? I saw you put up a video about that, the roundup starting, BGS. Yeah, the roundup should be starting. They should be grabbing every one of these motherfuckers. Yeah. BGS, we already know. That's why we already know. If it was me, I would be bathing in my waterboard right now. I would be. We already know that, but it ain't me. And as we know, I'm black. That's why that shit would be happening. It would be an insult to their sensibilities for somebody black to try some bullshit like that. White folks get the bill, get the, white folks get the, what is it? I just missed my word because somebody just texted me while I was streaming. No text while I'm streaming. That, white folks get the benefit of the doubt. They get to have that rebellious spirit welcomed and appreciated. We don't. Our rebellious spirit is usually tried to be tamped down or stomped out completely. Like many of these brothers on these channels with much larger channels than myself have said, our warriors get to go to prison. Our revolutionaries get to get killed. Our rebels, the people who buck against this fucking system and dumb shit that they see, get to get marginalized. They don't get to have fucking jobs. Or be security officers, shit. They don't. Because we are supposed to be that underclass. So, that statement about me being in Guantanamo, yeah, I would be. If I was out there doing this shit, they would have snatched my ass first. I'd have been the first one snatched or shot that day. I'm still waiting to hear who the other four people were that got killed, because all I keep hearing about is this chick. Who are the other four people? I see more coverage of COVID bodies than who these other four people were. And this just happened. Now, to the person who's texting me about how I feel about white people, I'll say this and try to be kind. Try to be kind about that, because I'm going to be probably scorpionic right now since Silent kicked it off. By and large, let's be diplomatic. Let me be diplomatic about it. I like people individually. No matter your color, I like you individually. When I say white people, by extension and mass as a group, I'm talking about anybody who looks at me and sees me as lesser. Go fuck yourself. Now, if you take offense to that shit because you may happen to be white, that is your fucking problem. That is not mine. I get the right as a black person in this country to say who and who the fuck I do not like and do not appreciate. And if I give a fuck if they die in a fire or get put out with an extinguisher. I do. You know why? Because I'm operating at the bottom of this bitch. Everything I have to gain, I have to gain against that WS bullshit. All of it. That's why I don't have to apologize. For shit. And because you know me personally, you know the personal shit I'm going through right now dealing with this same kind of shit. I do not have to be apologetic about it. Fuck all of you who agree with that kind of shit. If you cannot live in this country and see the plight that black people, specifically black men, go through in this country, then you are fucking blind. And living in a goddamn delusion. I cannot live in a delusion. I don't have the benefit of living in a delusion. I can't even fucking enjoy comic books now. Because I have to have that reality reinforced for me on a daily, hourly basis. Just like with your comment. Now, some of my best fucking friends, one of them in the fucking chat right now, who I would call like my damn son, is Caucasian. My family is full of mixed couples, Caucasians in them, loving them to death. Because I judge people individually, how you act to me as an individual. And if you do fucked up shit to me as an individual, black, white, yellow, red, green, dropped out from Mars yesterday, fuck your life. Fuck you. And everything about you. I don't have to be nice about that shit. Because it's not nice the way you're handling me. So BG, as you're saying, two cops died. They don't get to have their names known. These are people serving and protecting. They ain't going to put their names out there for condolences for their family and none of that shit. Because I don't think they was out there doing fucking wrong, were they? Just saying, I need to see the rest of this, not this piecemeal bullshit of information. Because to me, that's all about camera lens focus. Where you focus, but never giving you the full fucking picture. That doesn't look right to me, BGS. I'm just, from my instincts, it don't look right to me. It just don't look right. All that shit at the Capitol was fucked up. It was. It was no way around it. It was fucked up. It was a fucked up scene. A lot tamer than the summer, but a fucked up scene. Nothing got burned. They had zip ties and tear gas. Who the fuck was that? What was that about? And if the alphabet agencies had known about this shit days in advance and for the last 6 weeks, like everybody want to talk about online, then why the fuck was nobody prepared? Why weren't they looking to try to be prepared? It don't take a presidential decree to say, you know what, we've been hearing about some of this shit. We're going to have a little bit extra presence on the streets. Do that shit for a Raiders game. Come on. Anyway. Oh, my God. This racial shit. I was talking to my boy Chris from Fracture yesterday. And shout out to Chris. I should have sent him the link for this shit. But we were talking about this yesterday in the shop. And I was like, I told him, because I was watching the old video to see why it got blocked and see how I can edit it. And we were talking, having this conversation. I told him, so I'm waiting for all this racist shit to die. It's like past time with this shit. It should be dead already. And if it ain't dead already, I guess every black dude need to be going out and impregnating some of these white women so we can speed it up. Because at work, not at the shop, but at the main job, I was having this conversation about this dude and this white cat that was being hella racist on the job. And I'm sitting there in the elevator joking with the Latinos there. And I told him, so it's me, three Latino brothers, and my other brother, Phil, on my job, who they just let go. And we're talking, and I made the joke to him. I said, well, you know how you get his ass back, right? Said, that racist dude probably got a daughter. probably got a daughter, sister, niece, somebody. And they fucking a black dude. Have a baby. See how they like that shit then. See if he can hold on to that shit then. When his grandchild, new great nephew, niece, or some shit like that has to deal with that shit. See how he liked that shit then. Try it. Because I don't know about you, but when I make hot chocolate with milk and I drop that hot chocolate in that motherfucker, turn real brown. Don't work the other way. Don't work the other way. I can remember back in the 90s, I had a girlfriend. And she went back east. She was a military brat. She went back east and wanted me to come back east to North Carolina. And it turned out her fucking grandfather was like a Klan member or some shit like that. Thought that shit then. I said he should have a mixed grandchild. I didn't impregnate her, but I thought that's what he deserved. He deserved to have a mixed grandchild. Now, being that I have a mixed child and I've grown up in America, I know, and as me and Chris were talking about yesterday, all of us in this country is fucking mixed. If you're black, you're mixed. I am not this shade just because there ain't never been no white folks in my family. Phenotype, genotype, that shit. But unless you're jumping down on the genetic level, you can't say. We all do. That's why it's so fucking ridiculous. I got Irish on both sides, paternal and fraternal sides of my family. But I don't look Irish. But it's there. Because Irish has slaves too. And fuck them. So this whole thing with race, to me, this is another outdated concept that needs to go away. That needs to die on the vine. And I don't have a problem necessarily with folks, if they want to be racist, be fucking racist. You can be a bigot all fucking day long. Be a bigot. I don't give a shit. But what I get into is the racist part of it, where you use institutions to let your bigotry hinder other people. I don't have a problem with you not liking certain things. I'm bigot against dick. I'm a lesbian. Bigoted all day. I want no parts of it. Don't mean they all got to disappear. Just mean I ain't into it. Don't like that shit. I'm a lesbian. I like vagina. Now, it's a joke, but still, you get the point. I don't have a problem with you not liking shit. Good. Can't do nothing about it, though. That's the world you live in. That's the universe you were born into. In the words of BGS, suck it up, buttercup. Act like it's a hurdle and get the fuck over it. But when you use that bigotry to actually hinder other people, hurt them in their livelihood, like that has happened to me, that's when it's a problem. That's when it's racism. That's the part that needs to be stamped the fuck out. You will fuck about people not like me. I may not even like them. What difference do it make? Do your shit over there. Leave me the fuck alone. I will leave you the fuck alone and do my shit over here. It's very fucking simple. Like I've told you guys before, I worked in construction with straight up racist Klan members and worked side by side with them. You leave that shit at the gate. When we on this job site, we need to work together and get this shit done so we can all go home. I want to go home to my girl. You want to go home and do your racist shit to your sheets and pillowcases, whatever the fuck you want to do, fine. Do this shit correctly on the job. I'll make sure you live and you can go out and be racist another day. But leave that shit at the gate. You can pick that shit back up when you leave with your lunchbox. Because inside of here, this ain't how this shit gonna work. Because there's some shit we need to work on together. I take that to that mentality into the rest of the world. Do your shit where you do your shit. I don't give a fuck. I won't be doing it with you. Yo, I'm about done with all these people in this bullshit. I don't see the point of getting wrapped up in all of this shit and champion one and criticizing the other. It's just really fucking, it's really weak to me as black folks. We shouldn't be arguing with each other about this. I've seen people who were cool with each other forever now at odds with each other over fucking political figures. Are we still black folks? I thought we were. Thought we were still black folks. And that we need to be on one accord with each other to get the things that we need to be happening for us. Especially black men. Predominantly black men. Going at odds with each other for some dumb shit. Somebody else's ideology, somebody else's goddamn issues, somebody else's fucking politics. No, I can't. Can't do it. Like I told my daughter before this damn election, I will never and never want us to come at odds with each other over my motherfucking politics. Never. Because these motherfuckers will do whatever the fuck they want to for 4 years or more. We are blood. We are family. We don't come at odds with each other over these motherfuckers. They the out-group. We the in-group. We are the tribe. They are not. I will not cross my blood for nobody. I will check my blood all day about doing some dumb shit about crossing blood for other folks. I'm not crossing it. This is my union. And I'm crossing picket lines. So, these folks doing that dumb shit, it was dumb. It was a dumb move. It was out of control. Yeah, it was. Did the Orange and Cheese say some dumb shit while he's standing up on the podium? Yeah, he did. Is it impeachable? Possibly. Well, does he need to be impeached? No. Just get the fuck out. Just get the fuck out. Because to me, somebody with that big of an ego, to me, and this is me speaking directly to BGS, to me, for someone with that big of an ego to have to take a loss like that, contested or not, it's a loss, motherfucker, right? Him having to stand up there at inauguration and hand that shit over to Biden, he dies a little bit doing that shit. He does. him having to walk out of that Oval Office, get on the fucking helicopter, and wave to people who possibly giving him the fucking finger hurts him a little bit. And then he gets to fly off into the sunset and go the fuck away for another 4 years. A whole lot can happen in 4 years. We ain't had 1 year of COVID. You seen how much has changed and happened in that time within fucking 3 months. BGS, I'm not saying he's above the law. I'm not saying he's above the law. But trust me, in a lot of ways, you're smarter than me, BGS. You know that motherfucker gonna pay some kind of way. Motherfucker's gonna make him pay. Fucking what's his name? Jack Dorsey making him pay right now the way he can by keeping him banned permanently from Twitter. You know that's killing his ass. He can't say what he wanna say and get to reach his fans. You know that's killing him. What do you do with somebody who needs that much goddamn attention, BGS? Cut him off from it. That's how you hurt him. I'd make him stand up there. I'd make him stand up there at inauguration, because him choosing to not show up to inauguration is not facilitating the peaceful transfer of power. I'd make his ass stand up there. You don't get to be a child and stomp your feet and be like, well, I'm not going to show up because I'm mad. I don't give a fuck if you're upset. Be furious. Just stand your ass on that X and hand over the football. That's all the fuck you need to do. That's all you need to do. That's your job. It's over. Obama had to do it for you. You have to do it for Biden. And I don't fucking like Biden. But this is what's supposed to happen, motherfucker. Play your role. Do your job. This is your part of the job to do. Do it. This is the last thing you get to do. Do it. Get up there. Perform, monkey. That's what you're supposed to do. That's your job. So, no, you don't get to... Oh, well, I would have his ass up there with bells on. With bells on. Or then you would be, you know what? You get up there and you're going to hand over this football to the incoming administration. And you're going to smile and you're going to be fucking nice. If you do not do that, we were going to lock your ass up 5 minutes after that. Your ass will be in the deepest, darkest fucking prison we can find, with some spray tan, pulling that shit off with a sander. You'd be one of them presidents whose Secret Service detail magically disappeared one night and somebody came into your residence. What happened? You had to take a piss. Come on, man. Get back like that, BGS, will never be public. It'll never be public. And trust me, this motherfucker is going to get so much blowback as being an ex-president and not the sitting president. He might not be able to get another business started in this country. He may not be. Motherfuckers so up in arms about that shit, Republicans and Democrats. Oh, they're gonna put the screws to him. He gonna get some punishment, BGS. It may not be the impeachment of him being president, but he gonna get some payback. Oh, trust me, this motherfucker's lined up, waiting to take a turn to his ass. Trust me. So, I don't even worry about that part. That's why I say, let his ass just stroll off. Let him stroll off. Make him stand on his ex. And then go away. And if he nut up a little bit in 4 years and he want to try to run again, good luck with that shit. I know motherfuckers will come out in droves more than they say they came out for this last election to make sure his ass never see a ticket. Telling you, he couldn't get elected president of a lemonade stand at this point. Mm-mm. No, BGS, I can't say he was born either, but that's what I said when he got elected. I didn't even vote in that fucking election. But I said that this is going to be material for any comedian for the next 4 years. If you can't make no money telling jokes about this motherfucker for the next 4 years, you ain't even funny. You're not. He was going to be the most entertaining fucking president they had because he'd do too much dumb shit anyway. Too much dumb shit. It was not going to go unnoticed. Trust me. Appreciate the cash apps, Double C and BGS. Appreciate that. BGS, I don't know if you didn't see it earlier. We had your boy Silent on here. So, the rest of this shit, I'm just trying to puzzle through the shit myself. Because mind you guys, like I told BGS and Art on Art of Ibmore's panel, I was at work while this shit was going on. And I was in a spot where I didn't have cell phone reception. So it wasn't like I could pop on the YouTube and watch and see what was going on. I'm hearing stuff from other people. And then when I got off work, I'm hearing stuff from other YouTube people talking about what was going on, but I still hadn't seen any really of the images except this goofy fake ass dime store Indian walking through, you know, the halls with this Village People shit on. And I saw the picture for a brief second, like, what the fuck is this? The Village People at the Capitol? What the fuck is this? But I didn't see the rest of the report because once I came out of work, all these alerts are popping up on my phone for people's channels and news reports and breaking news and all this shit. That's my own shit I'm dealing with. I'm not looking at all this shit at the moment. Could not. But when I start hearing and getting more of a sense of what's going on, I kept hearing, yeah, there was a riot. Yeah, it was a commotion to storm the Capitol. I'm like, first thing I want to know is a map. It's like, spatially, how far away are these things happening and how are these people getting here and where's the goddamn police and what the fuck? When I finally saw video of this shit, I was like, just look like some shit in Davis. Some serious little protest in Davis. Okay, see, this is why we do not disturb during the shows, because some people don't know how to respect work. Yeah, we do need Cat Williams, James Q. I'd take a George Carlin. I would. What's good, AB Media? There's a George Carlin joke that I was looking for, or a clip I was looking for, because I remember the joke. The joke is, it's called the American Dream because you have to be asleep to believe it. It's a fucking dream. These motherfuckers own you. Right? This changeover that you're seeing is just that, changeover of ownership, and we going after the people that you weren't. Because before all of this shit, when they were talking about the going after the supporters and stuff like that, after the new administration went in, people was thinking they was fucking crazy, like they would be doing some fucking German post-war trials and shit, right? Well, do you think anybody would be against that shit now? That means that this whole riot situation was pretty advantageous then, wasn't it? Got public support behind that shit that sounded goofy a month or so ago when they planned it out. See, I don't put stuff like this past politicians. I don't. You don't need everybody involved on it for this something like this to happen. All you need is a few people in key spots. That's it. Once you got that, everything else can happen. It's good for them. So, like, share, subscribe, support the stream. If you're in here, you should be supporting the stream. I'm going to share this for an intermission while I try to wring my brain out and entertain the rest of us at the same time. There's still a lot of people who died this week, and all of their deaths are getting overshadowed by all the rest of this dumb shit. So this video messed up last week, so I'm going to just do this while I cleanse my mind. Because a couple of other notable black people died this week as well. And as goofy as this dancing look, it makes me feel good to see it. Shout out to Shabadoo. And the classic movie Breaking 2. For the two of you that just left, deuces. I need this clip. I used to dance like that, y'all. Not like that. I didn't do the locking shit. But this is 80s. So I did have a red parachute pass with the black shirt. And the Pumas with the fat laces. Couldn't help it. Yeah, shout out. Actually, double C. Shout out to Deezer D. And Christopher W., yes, you should subscribe. I don't know who you are, but if you're a troll, you'll get bought or something. Artie Inmore, I have no cookies for you, doughboy. What's up, Dr. T? Breaking 2 brought Dr. T out. Uh-oh. Dr. T breakdancing in the office. That was a garbage-ass move. I just wanted to share that because a couple of times I was trying to give RIP respects to some of the brothers who passed, Ecstasy and Shabadoo, and the video, when I went back and watched the video, it had messed up. So you didn't even get to hear the song. You didn't see the video. So it fucked up. So I wanted to make sure they got their respect. And I've been getting alerts all week from my buddy Sam, about all these people that passed this week, because he keeps up with all that stuff. And since last week, he was breaking it down to me, or showing me everybody who had passed, and it was just like one person after another this last week. So I'm going to read these off, and you'll see. And then I'll talk about that whole Dr. Dre shit, too. I got some thoughts on that as well. Apparently we chat too much because it's too much to go through. Okay. This motherfucker. Okay, so who was the first one he sent me? So the first one he sent me was Tanya Roberts. Now, if y'all don't know Tanya Roberts, she was a Bond girl when he did the A View to a Kill in San Francisco with Christopher Walken, Grace Jones, Roger Moore. Not my favorite Bond, but he was one. Don't give a fuck. The group Fishbone made a brief appearance in Breaking 2. Yeah, you're right about that, Malika. You're right. So, Tanya Roberts was in the little-known movie that most of y'all wouldn't remember unless you about my age, BGS age, Dr. T, Malika, some of these older cats in here might, who watch shitty movies would know that if you remember Sheena, the princess of whatever the fuck she was, this is who Tanya Roberts was. Now, she was kind of a hot chick back in the day. Back in the 70s, she posed in Playboy and all the rest of that stuff. She wasn't hard on the eyes, right? So she's been in some stuff that I remember. So, okay, it's sad for her passing. It's a white chick. That doesn't matter to me necessarily. People who I actually have watched on television and give somewhat of a shit about, no, passing is a tough thing, you know, especially during this COVID. The number of people who are dropping right now during COVID is like fucking ridiculous, dude. They're going way too quick. And so that's why I'm always trying to hear if it was COVID related or if they just, you know, expired due to natural causes because they were old as shit. What you keep finding is a lot of these people are not really old. Not really that damn old. Not old enough to just be dropping dead all of a sudden. Sheena, Queen of the Jungle. Was that the title of that damn movie? Oh my God. Uh-oh. Yeah, I gotta do it. Yeah. Y'all gonna get a treat. I gotta do it. I gotta do it. Just to change gears. I know everybody else gonna leave now as soon as I change gears to non-political talk. Seeing as politics and vagina is the only thing that get people to bump their numbers up. But let me give y'all that full screen effect. Let me get that up there. So that's Tanya Roberts riding the zebra. And I fall with Paul Mooney on this. I think it was a Paul Mooney joke. About that black folks been in Africa forever. You got Tarzan, you got Sheena, the queen of the jungle, Tarzan, the king of the jungle. Black folks have been in Africa forever and can't talk to a damn monkey. Get the fuck out of here. Ridiculous, dude. I watched that movie a couple of times, Dr. G, I did. I mean, I was a young cat that liked seeing boobs. She was half naked. What the fuck am I supposed to do? I have natural hormones, dude. I have natural hormones. I told you, I am a lesbian. I've been a lesbian since I was born. Big lesbian. Big lesbian. Why is this shit still going? Turn this shit off. Okay. Look, man, it was the, what, 80s, 90s? Here's the fuck it is. It is what it is. Yeah, I've seen that movie a couple times, Dr. T. I have seen it a couple times. Because it's just a movie. I was young. I wasn't thinking about all the racial implications or none of that shit. I'm just watching a goddamn movie. It was on HBO. What are you going to do? So, yeah, she died at 65 last week. And who else? Well, that's from the grave. This other chick died too, Erica Meadows. Is that it? Oh no, this is Tanya Roberts still. Yeah. She had those eyes. Women with those really clear eyes like that creep me out. Like, where is she at? She in the chat right now. This laughing person right there. She got them same kind of damn eyes. Creepy eyes. I look at her, but get kind of scared. So who else is that? Deezer D died. I heard about that. And if y'all don't know who Deezer D is, I believe he might have been a rapper, but I recognize him from ER. And if I can find a picture of him on ER, it would actually help. Let me get this shit off the screen. Let's see if we can find a picture of Deezer D. Oh, they got his cause of death up here, too. Damn. Damn, son. All right, so we got Deezer D up here. The happy brother. Brother right there. Now, I watched ER a lot. Loved ER. And I liked his character on ER. Him and Eric LaSalle and some of the other characters on there. I really did enjoy on there. So, yeah, that's right. He was, yeah, Malika. See, I know Malika. You coming in the clutch, homeboy. Yeah, he was tone deaf, right? He was tone deaf in CB4. That's right. I know Malika. Good catch. You got a picture of Tall Death on this motherfucker? Yep. There you go. Malika has spoken. Yeah, so, you know, shout out and respects to him for, you know, making his contribution to the world. My whole thing with people in remembering their passing and giving respects to their passing is that being able to make your mark in this world and have people know who you are in some sense can be an accomplishment, you know? And you're born, you're supposed to, you know, at least make your mark on the world in some kind of way. And if you can do that, great. A lot of people die without being able to do that, which is a sad thing, because they could have had something really to give to the world that never got, you know, looked at. The other one who passed that was kind of disappointing was Marion Ramsey. And if you don't know who Marion Ramsey is, Marion Ramsey was Hooks from the Police Academy movies. She died at 73. Now, you can say the Police Academy movies was shit. They're shit movies. It wasn't until I got older that I realized how much way too adult humor was going on. And I'm seeing it as a kid, but I like watching movies like that to go back and see where some of these stars that we know and loathe nowadays actually come from. And of course you got Steve Guttenberg, you got all these people in this cast, but you also got like Sharon Stone and stuff like that, Kim Cattrall, people showing up. Yep, Dr. T, Hooks died. Hooks is dead. Don't move, dirtbag. She is gone. That's not a gift. Hooks are gone. I can't hear you. Yeah, let me do that. See if I can do it correctly. Hooks. open link in a new tab. Open mention tab. Let's see. And then control. Let's see if that worked. I'll remove that one. Stop that one. And share this one. There you go. That's Marion Ramsey. Yeah, the iconic curl. Measly me, you not shit. It was the 80s, dude. We all had those. We all had curls. It just wasn't always juicy. Iconic curl. Yeah, so that's Marion Ramsey. Oh, you ain't even talking about shit, Arda Ibmore. Stop buying all them damn variant covers. But yeah, she passed last week as well during all that, the rest of that shit that was happening. You know, some people were actually living and losing their life that weren't involved with a bunch of political shit. Then there was another one that I heard about from somebody else, but Sam wasn't the one who told me about it, and I don't recall who it was at the moment. So, yeah, people have been dropping like flies around here. I need that gift, man. I need that don't move dirtbag gift. Where's that gift? Where is that gift? I'll take this one. Sorry, you guys. I got to keep my Giphy game up since everybody using GIFs now. Especially Dr. T stole my GIF, my blade GIF. So, a lot of people have been passing, and trying to keep up with everything that happens in the world, you will miss some stuff. And some of these people, they may not be beloved to everybody. Like I said, Police Academy was seen as some shitty movies. I seen all of them, though. I watch them again because they're still funny. But all these people need to be paid their respects the same way as all this political bullshit goes on, and we let that suck up all the air and the space to talk about anything else. I mean, it happens. It doesn't happen. Shit. Ah, shit, new comments. Yeah, Bubba's been gone for a while. Who's Bubba? Died in 2000. Oh, yeah. Bubba Parrish? Yeah. Yeah, he's been gone for a minute. He's been gone for a minute. It is a GIF for it. GIF. I don't know what the acronym is for. I'm sure the F is for format, graphic interface format or something like that. I don't know. That's just my guess. But I'm sure that's what it is. Yeah, say, measly me, you are right. Say no to the Blue Oyster Bar. No. And if you're ever in San Francisco, never let somebody convince you to go to the tea room. You do not want to go to the tea room. Do not. Do not. You know what it is? Look it up on your computer. I ain't looking it up on mine. Not at all. Yes, for graphic. Well, it's graphic, not peanut butter. That was a good one, Aqua Techie. Damn, I wish this was like Twitch. I can give you points for that. That was a good comeback, dude. Score for Aqua Techie. It's graphics, not peanut butter. Yeah. Ford don't even like regular peanut butter anyway. He a fucking Nutella eater. Oh, I was right. Graphic interchange format. Thank you, Arda Imore. Somebody did do some tech shit. Pretty good at breaking down acronyms. Pretty good at making them, too. So, what else has been in the space? Because the political shit was the first thing on my mind that was bothering me. And then brothers, you know, falling out with each other or arguing with each other over this stuff. A lot of people are using this as cause to beat their drum and get a smile and get support for themselves and have their views heard. And I guess that's all well and good. It is what it is. But I just wanted to say my piece on it without being shouted down or called all kind of other shit, because I just want to say what the fuck I want to say and be done with it. You can agree, you cannot agree. That's perfectly fine. But I do get to say what I want to. And since I actually make content and do live streams, I can say what the hell I want to on my platform, unobstructed. That's what I suggest a lot of these motherfuckers that just like to come on panels and be arguing people do. Get on your fucking channel and say that shit. Because if people really want to hear it, they'll come to your channel and listen to it. And if they don't, well, you know where that shit falls. So, I don't agree with the riot and shit. I don't. But I'm not agreeing with the politicians necessarily either. Let that man do his walk of shame and stand on his ex and hand over them codes and get the fuck on out of there. That shit is done for him. Fight your fight in court. If you disagree and if you really think you're wrong, come back again in 4 years and we'll see what you got. Chances are you will not be elected again for anything. It's a good chance of that. So I'm not worried about him coming back. Does he need to be impeached? It's impeachable, but no, just let him go. If this would happen December, yes. Impeach his ass. 2 weeks? Nah, your notice is in already, dude. You're gonna... Nah, never mind. Just pack up your shit. Maybe you move out early and just show up, you know, on inauguration day. Maybe you move out early. You done. So, moving on. I have not concentrated on a lot of geek stuff this week because a lot of it has been rehash. A lot of it has been rehashing some stuff. Like, share, subscribe, support the channel. Only got 5 people as my ex-father-in-law would say. I think we only got 5 people. More 6 people. Oh, Joe Herb snuck in. What's up, Herb? Appreciate you for the cash out, Herb. Appreciate that. So, in other news, since I got all of you here, the shop. I am buying the shop. And what am I showing you guys? I'm not going to show you all the work, all the paperwork, but this is some of the paperwork for my business license and my seller's permit, my California reseller's permit and stuff for buying the shop. Next step is my old employer owes me a chunk of change. So I'm going to take that chunk of change and roll it into the shop to purchase the shop. The GoFundMe that I have set up is for the shop, but it's for renovations and stuff like that to the shop and things I want to change in the shop. So because no money has changed hands yet, it is still not my shop, but everything else is going forward. This is just paperwork that needs to be completed and filed. But because December 31st for me, through a bunch of other stuff on my plate that all needs to happen now at the same time, I'm in a little bit of a crunch to get certain things done. So, appreciate that, brothers. Yeah, for Herb, yeah, you definitely need to beef up your saber. And thank you, Dr. T. I'll be really happy when money is exchanged hands and shit like that, because then that will be, that's when I'll start really owning it as mine. I'm saying this part now, but money has to change hands. As long as the money changes hands, we good. Now, the GoFundMe I set up is not for a shitload of money. It's not to buy the place. I'm buying the place with my own money. That's not what the GoFundMe is for. The GoFundMe is for me to do the changes to the place that I want to do. I do want to paint it. I do want to get the fucking heater fixed. I do need to buy more comics since we've been running a sale for the last couple of months. We are running low on stock. I need to do that, and I need to get a new point of sale system, one that works for ordering comics and stuff like that. So as to get it up and running and make some of those changes that I've talked about on this platform and in person with some of my other friends to get it done. So I'll put the link up there, Malika, because I want to shoot a new video for the GoFundMe, because the video is not specific to the GoFundMe. The video is from my YouTube page, and that doesn't seem to work for me. Doesn't seem to work for me and get across what's trying to be done. But I will say that, as far as I know, when money is exchanged hands and the shop has my name on it and it's mine, that will be the first Black-owned comic shop in El Cerrito. It will be the first Black-owned comic shop. I can't say it's the first Black-owned comic shop in the area, because I believe there was one in Hilltop, Richmond, Pinole area. I'm not sure because I never went to it, but I heard it was black owned, but I've never been to it, so I can't fucking say. So I didn't open up the GoFundMe right now. Let's see. Hold on a second. Might as well open it, I guess. It's still not public because I believe the bank account that you have to bank account for it has to be active before you can set it up, so they know where they would be depositing funds, and that is not open, and that needs to be opened in the store account. So it has to be opened in the store account so that money is not going into my fucking personal account, which I would never fucking want. I'm only doing this shit because somebody needs to do it, and I want their business to stay open. So it's not a personal gain for myself necessarily, outside of being responsible for a bunch of other extra shit and other people's livelihood besides my own. What's up? Share fundraiser. Resolutions. Okay. Share a copy link. Link copy to the board. Okay. So I can share screen on this. Okay. Yeah, Rhonda, a heater. Porter's in there right now. He can tell you a heater would be awesome. Update. Copy link. Thank you. Okay, let's see if that works. Looks like the link, hopefully it's the correct one, but if you cannot see, excuse me, if you cannot see, That is kind of what it looks like. And it'll sound funny, but as critical as my mother is, I actually want her to... Oh, should have got my government on there. And we're out of there. Well, that's not really a secret, necessarily. But there it is. So I dropped a link in there. I don't think I've set a time for it. I believed I was going to run it for 30 days. And then stop it. Just because I'm actually... Oh, three people left already. I'm actually going to have to move in the same time frame. So by the end of the month, I need to be moved and stuff like that. So getting the shop done, shop stuff done by the end of the month, as well as getting myself moved by the end of the month, is sucking up a lot of resources. That's why everything is rolling slow. Herb. I said tomorrow yesterday, but I'll actually mean it today. So tomorrow, I should have set this up already. I'm sorry, you guys. It's just a lot of stuff going on that I'm trying to handle and take care of while still working to earn for all of this shit. So it is going live. Just check back, copy that link and check back tomorrow on it, and it should be opened up for tomorrow. And I have to make my calls tomorrow to certain corporate entities to give me my motherfucking money and get that shit all taken care of and transferred. You probably have to take a day off of work to do all of this shit, which is interesting in this time, because this job should be finished by the end of the month as well. So they started firing a lot more people. And like I told you guys earlier, my homeboy Phil, they gave him the axe Friday, and a lot of other plumbers and stuff on that job have left. So they got me doing some little stuff around there, hanging out. So I'm trying to get all this stuff done before there is an actual, hopefully not a stall or a low period in the money. So you know how you do when you're black, you make it work. So everything else got paid off this week, so everything that comes in the next couple of weeks will be thrown towards the important stuff to get it done, son. So because all that is going on, a lot of geek stuff has been passing by the wayside for me, except for the fact that next week we have WandaVision showing up, which I'm looking forward to. But in terms of store geek stuff, let me say this before I get completely off talking about the store, because now this is all in my consciousness. One of the things I talked to Chris about yesterday while he was in the shop was ideas for the shop. And one of the things I want to do in the shop, once it's changed hands and names on leases and shit like that, is that I want to bring in more independent artists and comics. And I would say predominantly black independent artists and comics who have their own books, but I want to make a space where independent comic book creators like Black Sands or Concrete Comics and stuff like that can actually put their books into a store and have it sell. I want to make a space for that, because say Concrete or Black Sands can't get into Diamond Comics because Diamond is their main distributor. Say they can't get in there. Where else can you find their comics? Where else can you buy their books? Well, say they're on Comixology, maybe you can buy it on Comixology, and they'll print a one-for-one. So you buy a book, they print a book. Buy a book, they print a book. That's well and good too, right? Say you catch them at a con, Well, we're doing COVID right now. There ain't no fucking cons. You know, DC just did a whole fan dome and it wasn't a live person in the building. Okay, it was all virtual. Right? So my idea for people like my buddy Chris Fracture, Herb, if he ever finishes his comic, to be able to have a place where they can put their book into stores, into customers' hands, where even in a COVID environment, if you want to come in on a weekend and actually pump your book to people coming in the store, you can do that. You can actually just come in and promote your shit. So for me, I see it as a win in the sense that Black comic book creators, at least locally or around, can actually have their book in a store and point to a store where you can go in and buy their fucking book. You can go in and buy their book. If you're just a fledgling company and you're trying to sell some books, why don't you bring your shit over stand up? Artisan, you know, make a deal with you and you can put your books on the shelf. Because for the most part, at least in the independent racket, to me, it's more important to get your book seen by people who regularly buy comics than it is to just have a booth. To be honest, I've gone to a lot of cons. I've bought a lot of independent books off of comic creators out of Artist Alley, right? And to be honest with you, I can't say I've read all of them. Can't say that. Can't say that at all. And that's how it usually happens. But if you, as a creator, can sit there and talk to people that are buying comics in a comic book setting, not a, look, there's a naked girl over there dressed like, you know, Sheena, Queen of the Jungle. No, that you can talk to comic book buying public that are in a shop buying comics, the actual fucking geeks, and pitch them your book, you have a better chance of selling that book. Because then they know what it's about. Cons get congested. It's too much other distractions going on. But like me, in a one-to-one setting, I can pitch you anything. I can talk to you about what's going on with these characters, what's going on with this book, what's going on with this story. And the people best to explain that stuff outside of the people who have never read this material and it's all new is the actual creator himself. Actual creator of these comics themselves. Like, if you guys go on to our stand-up comics page, stand-up comics on Facebook, you will see videos up there from our free comic book days. And one of the videos that you'll see up there that I recorded and posted, is my boy Chris and Dave sitting at a table. Dave is drawing. Chris is talking about his books and got his books out there and just having a real interactive conversation with just somebody who's there about his books. That's what sells the books. It's not the art necessarily themselves, might not even be the story. But if you're a new comic book creator, you're making your first comics or your first books, you sell that shit. People buy it off of your passion about what's going on in the story. I read their books. That's not a joke. The Fracture books, I've read those books. I love that shit. I want to see more of it. I like that they're inspired to do it, and they're young brothers. I would like to see other brothers be able to have that opportunity to have their stuff out there, say it's in the store, and have people come looking for their book in that store to buy that book. The shop don't need a huge piece of that shit. You don't get a huge piece off the DC shit or the Marvel stuff. And in my state of mind, look, if all the rest of this bullshit is selling, people making whole fucking channels talking about all these shitty ass comics that's coming out, and talking about them, we can talk about your shitty comic too, if it's shitty. And if it's good, we can talk about that as well. So why not have a space? I can tell you, in the last 2 years, I've had several independent comic book creators call the shop doing the cold calls to try to get people and stores to buy their fucking comic. To look for their comic in Diamond if they can get it in there, or just request it from Diamond so it can be included, so you even know it's out there to be bought. You know what I've never seen in Diamond? Never seen Black Sands in Diamond. I don't remember seeing it in there ever. Only person I know who was ordering it was Joe Herb in the chat. Because you got to buy it from them directly. If they can get that shit out to more stores, they'd sell a lot more books. They'd be more profitable. You would have the uptake in Black characters that Black folks want to see, and not have them stifled behind where you got to get behind Black Panther or Black Lightning or somebody else, because that's all you're going to get. But you'll never see your fucking icon again. You'll never see your Static again. You'll never see any of those cool Black characters that was really about some shit. You won't see those again. You're only going to get the message we want. Transgendered or whatever. So I think it could be good. A lot of independent, creative, Black comic book creatures. Dr. Spawn Al Simmons. I follow Concrete Comics on my Instagram. I follow them. And the covers look good. The covers look awesome. I wish I could see them in stores. And that's kind of the idea for, they need to be in stores. What's the problem with them putting these books in stores and making a deal directly with the store to ship them some books, you know, every month? They'll put their book on the shelf, and what they sell, they send them back a cut and they keep a cut. What the fuck is the problem with that? That's business. You can start your own fucking distribution out of that kind of thinking. Have not seen it. Okay, so Herb, you haven't even seen it in Diamond either, see? I haven't seen it in the previews. I have not seen it in the previews. But that summer, not last year, but the year before, when I was getting at least three calls in the shop from comic book creators wanting you to buy their book or sending out mailers with their books in it, like, look, this is the new book that's coming out. You guys should order it. Where did that shit go? It either went in the garbage or I had to tell them no, because it wasn't my choice to make. But these are people who are wanting a chance. And some of the art looked great. I can't say what was going on with the story because it was in a garbage can before I ever saw it. But why not? We got bins and bins of stuff at the shop right now of mainstream comics that are shit. That basically the shop has lost money for having. It ain't worth cover prices anymore. And it may not even be a year old. What's wrong with selling some of these independent books? Just saying. So it's an idea. So that's one of the things I want to do with it, with the shop, once, you know, pens to ink and money is exchanged. That's one of the things I want to do with it. The other thing is I want to increase the online presence, so people like a Double C or Arta Idmore, they want something from the store. If we got it in stock, I'll ship it to you. You ain't got to go through fucking Amazon. I'll ship it to you. Yeah, it'll cost you a little more, but I'm not fucking Amazon. That's why it'll cost you a little more. But it shouldn't be any different than buying from some seller on Amazon. I think, and it just means the people in the building at the shop have to actually do some fucking work. I don't have a problem with that. Yeah, you don't buy all the extra covers for a reason, but that's kind of predicting the demand in the audience. Or even more, I can tell you just from knowing that process, you're gauging this stuff 3 months in advance, and say, just say 3 months ago, buying Batman was soft. The sales were lower than they had been in the last 2 years. And now I have to buy for the next 3 months, 3 months out. 3 months from now, this is coming out. What's going to be the draw on this? Well, my Batman sales have been going down for the last 6 months. How many of this next run, 3 months from now, am I going to buy? Might not be that strong. Oh, they got five different covers. Yeah, fuck all that. No, I'm not buying all those covers. You got pictures of the covers? Well, we got pictures of two of them out of the three. Okay, so who's doing the other covers? Well, we got one by Jim Lee. Well, what does it look like? No picture, no image yet. Well, I have to order this shit now. That's the kind of things that you're dealing with when you're buying comics for a comic book store. Those are the type of things that you're fucking dealing with. So you have to project 3 months in advance what you think the demand will be in and try to play it safe. So say you bought five of the regular covers or 10 of the regular covers, five of cover A, five of cover B. You're sitting on 20 books at that point. The shit comes out, nobody likes it. You pay for all 20 of those books. You better hope they sell. Now say it's just a mediocre story and people didn't like cover B. Well, you now you just ate it on cover B. Maybe you didn't buy cover C. And everybody wants cover C for some reason, some weird reason. Say there was a shadow of a bat penis on it. Now you have to go back and try to reorder cover C, which they didn't print a lot of because nobody ordered it. And now you got a customer standing in front of you who doesn't want to wait 2 weeks to get the shit. That's why it's a hard game, dude. It's a hard fucked up game because you're in the position of trying to look through your crystal ball and figure out what people are going to fucking want. And if you figured wrong or don't have enough of it on hand for them, you have to figure out how to get it quickly. And if they will wait, the 30 seconds is going to take you just to look it up and see if you can order it right away. But even then, since we don't have that teleportation technology worked out or that tenant technology yet, you got to wait for it to get here. People don't want to fucking wait. Even though when you order on Amazon, you have to fucking wait. I don't get it. People are too goddamn impatient nowadays. $75 off the rip? Fuck you. That better be a one per comic shop variant for $75. It better be a one per comic shop variant. Hell no. Aquatechie, that'd be a good move if they actually thought about that shit. They would sell more reprints that way. Oh, well, apparently y'all Dr. Spawn said my content is lacking. Go ahead, Dr. Spawn, throw your idea in there. Hold on a second. Let me get this shit ready. All right, Dr. Spawn. Hit me with it. Throw it out there. Throw it in there. I listen to your shit because you at least hear. Like, share, subscribe, support the stream. I'm a bad salesman, but I do can talk about ideas. So. I want a big titty Amazon woman that will cause death by soon as soon. Arda Ibmore, what the hell is wrong with you, dude? Today, what's wrong with you? I would say at least 2 or 3 covers just for the first 2 issues. It depends on the issues. If you can see the stuff sometimes when you're ordering through Diamond, it makes it easier. Sometimes they don't have an image yet because the artist or the company is not finished with the fucking art. They haven't decided on the final art. So it makes it a little tough. But if you can predict where you're going to be 3 months from now, and you're not in control of where the car goes, then you're a genius. Dr. Spawn, I thought about that as well. Another part of my idea is that if I actually, money's changed hands, I own the shop, that I would stream from the shop every Saturday. I would live stream from the shop every Saturday because I'm in the shop every Saturday. I mean, only other business that I've owned is my independent contracting, which was just me. And I always thought that if I owned a business or a bigger business, I would still work. I'm an ox. I'm a Scorpio ox. I don't feel right if I don't have my hands in what's going on. It doesn't feel right at all. I'd rather be doing the work. Even when I worked corporate and I was in charge of running my 14-man team or 14-person team, I did the work alongside everybody else because I like doing the work. I like comics. I like being in the shop. I don't have a problem handling customers. I like talking to customers, especially about comics and getting them to find something that they actually like or getting their kid to find something that he or she actually likes. I like that. I like that interaction. I like dealing with families and that are getting into comics or bringing the kids' interests or bringing parents back to reading comics. I just want something good to pitch them. I do. Can't keep pitching them the same shit. Can't. They need to see some more stuff. If you want to talk like Chris was mentioning yesterday about working on a movie, said if you want to talk diversity, diversity has to mean something more than just we put more women in it. But you're all still Caucasian white men and women. That's not diversity. It's not diversity. Yeah, Artie, more 12 different covers for a comic is dumb and crazy. I kind of blame Jim Lee for that shit. Kind of. I don't know why, but that always associates in my mind to Gen 13 and 13 different variant covers for his book. I always equate that shit to him. For some reason, that's why. 13 different fucking covers is ridiculous. Because even in... as being an editor in DC, he's done those multiple variant covers again. Of like, fuck are you doing? I can't see how that actually makes any sense. Regular cover, variant cover. That should be fucking it. Maybe if you went 3 or some really big event, maybe 4. Maybe 4. But it should be tiered down because comic shops have to buy all of these books. And when they don't fucking sell, they have to sit on all these books and eat that shit. That's what kills comic shops. That whole glut through the damn 90s, or excuse me, the 80s and 90s of all those overbought comics is the reasons why stuff from the 80s and 90s, Ford can tell you, we don't even fucking buy because it's too much of it. It's oversaturated. Created a bubble like they create and everything else that's busted. Yeah, Empire and Eternals, they only needed 2 variant covers. That's all they fucking needed. That story was not that damn good anyway. Um, Dr. Spawn, if I was able to interview Todd McFarlane, I would. Now, I'll show you this shit just so we know who ain't bullshitting around this motherfucker. Is it here? No, I gotta go the other way. Gotta go the other way. Got to go the other way. Now, I can say that I've met Todd McFarlane. And that picture was taken after I had a little bit of a conversation with him. We talked for about a minute or two about his whole idea on being an entrepreneur. And that the entrepreneur sees the cliff, steps back and gets a running start at it, and jumps and figures out how to fly on the way down. That was his conversation to me, and that was at Image Comic 20 of Image Comics. So if I could interview Todd McFarlane, I would. If I could interview any of the comic book creators, I would. I just don't have a big enough, I don't think I have a big enough platform right now to reach out to them and get that kind of feel, because it wouldn't be beneficial to them. Like, I got, 26 people in here right now, and only, 5, 6 out of the 30 at one point we had in here have actually donated to the fucking channel. So if one of these people wanted to come on and I want to pay them for coming on, for spending their time to come on, what would I pay them with? How would it be beneficial to them? So the 20 people in my audience, 6 of them can buy their book. Kind of beneficial. I think at low numbers, you should look for 100% of participation. Higher numbers, you can look for half. Lower numbers, but, look, I'm not a business person like that. I just think some things should be supported more than others. Batman, Catwoman, wedding was crazy, but whatever. And Tom Fawn doesn't care if you have 3K subs, try interviewing him. That'd be good, because I've been a Todd McFarlane fan for a while. I'm definitely a Spawn fan. Spawn all over my shit. So if I got the Todd McFarlane endorsement to keep using Spawn without getting blocked or sued, I'd love that shit. I just saw somebody on watching a Spawn the animated series yesterday. Well, not yesterday, but Friday, Thursday, my coworker. He hadn't seen the HBO animated Spawn show, and I told him you need to go and watch that shit, to go binge it with your girlfriend and have a good time. She feels so colorful. Yeah, see, Ford is one of these ones. He's a comic book worker who will go to other people's comic shops and pump up their shit. I like that, Ford. That's loyalty. But they do stuff like that at different comic shops. Yeah, Flying Colors out where we are usually has a lot of artists being able to come in and stuff like that, because they have some connections to some of the other comic book creators. But they're a bigger store in a market that is mostly suburban, with upper class or middle class white folks and kids and stuff like that, so they get a lot more people through their fucking shop. Yeah, fancy as variants, good advice. Yeah, he's a legend. Yeah, I give Todd McFarlane his respect. He is a legend. What's up, She? We here? She, we here? We here? We here now? What's up, She? Pay them in exposure. Ford, this is the funny part about exposure. They actually have more exposure than me, so it's not exposure for them. It's exposure for me. But maybe it's a small audience that they don't. They need a return on their investment. They're investing an hour of their time to come into my little virtual shop and talk comics for a little while. How much exposure do they get? Who is it really helping? I could try it. I don't have a problem trying this shit. I'm cynical sometimes. So it is what it is. Why don't they sell a book of covers or put the variant cover in a special edition? BGS, they do that sometimes. They will do, I've seen issues like that before where it's just all variant covers. It's just a book of fucking variant covers. That's all it is. But the nature of the comic book market is that they want you to buy more comics. That's why they'll put a different cover on it, because you can charge a different price for the cover. Because say your regular issue is about $4. Variant cover is like $7. Like seven, and they don't produce as many of it. That's what drives the value up. This is why they understand the supply and demand part, but sometimes they go way the fuck overboard, like they don't understand it, and make too many damn covers for these things. Like, the story wasn't that good. Did y'all think about this? Did you read it before you decided to do 12 different covers? But because I think it's because they're planning this stuff so far out. And you have to guess at that demand. That's why it's hard that some things fall short, some things hit just right, and some things fall way fucking short. Maximum Clonage, ugh. Death of Superman, you can still find copies of that shit all over the place. And it ain't worth garbage. It's not worth, look, Ford will use that for Christmas wrapping paper. Because there's so much of this stuff around. It's tough. Yeah, but I'm not talking about, you know, reforming the whole comic book market, because I can't do that. I'm just talking about what I want to do with one store I want to buy. I can only make my ways in the way that I can make them, where I can make them, make a difference where I can. I can't change the whole comic book industry. If I could, I would have did it yesterday, because I want people like BGS reading comics. Sitting down with his grandson, reading comics and having a plethora of titles that he can choose from that actually speak to something in his grandson and actually promote something he wants his grandson to actually see, adopt, and understand. I would like that. And I don't think that's coming from the major labels right now. It's not coming from the big comic book companies. I do think it may come from some of the independent ones. And I'm not saying that every comic book character needs to be black to tell a story that black folks can resonate with. I'm not that fucking simple-minded. But I do think that more representation and more stories from a multi-ethnic perspective would be helpful. And not all about sex. I'm for throwing all the sex away out of the comic books altogether. Because initially, you are trying to sell this to children. And if you're selling sex to children, that's, in my opinion, you're doing something way wrong. You sell sex to adults. You don't sell sex to children. And that's why I can't sell that kind of stuff to them. Dr. Spawn, you're right twice. Malika, I'm trying to seize it, dude. I am trying to seize it. Like I said, it's just a lot of extra stuff in the background of this YouTube shit going on in my life. It's all taking precedence at the same time. And it's serious. It's some serious stuff. But I can share a little bit of it with you right now. So I found out last Tuesday, which is shout out to Art Neustadt and Art of Immore and AB Media. The reason why I wasn't on Black Artists on the Spot is that I got a call from my sister. And I'm using this story to explain a point. I'm not looking for fucking sympathy or anything like that. Okay. I'm just explaining the point of the type of shit I have going on in the background. My sister hit me up on Facebook Messenger. I hadn't talked to her in a bit. And my sister is 4 years younger than me. Same father, different mother, so we didn't actually grow up together. And my sister calls up and tells me that, hey, she's doing okay after her surgery on her tumor that she had in her head, and she's doing okay. And I'm like, the fuck? You had a tumor? When? When did you go into the fuck? So she texts me a little bit more. It's like, yeah, I had a tumor in my brain and it had to get operated on. What's up, Tutriv? I thought Daddy would have told you. I'm like, I talked to Pops on Christmas and that's not his business to be fucking telling me. That's yours. So I called my sister. Video call. She wasn't looking too good. And when I initially kind of cussed her out a little bit, like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Why don't you contact me about these things and let me know what the fuck is going on? This is important. I kind of went in on her a little bit because I don't know if it's like this in everybody's black families. My black family, the family that I'm a part of, maybe it's just because of me, I don't fucking know. But these motherfuckers will get at you about all the dumb shit that's going on with people. Who got into a fight, who ain't talking to who, and had an argument with whoever. But when real serious shit is happening, you'll never get a fucking call. You don't know anything about it. And so I got on my sister telling her, like, look, this is not something I needed to be finding out after a fucking fact. Yes, you went through the surgery and everything was good. Do you think I would have wanted to find out that you had a fucking brain tumor and were going through surgery after you died? No. What the fuck? You have my number. It doesn't change. I love you. You need to be contacting me about shit like that. I'm not saying I can do anything about it, but at least I fucking know what's going on. So I went in on her. Now she's fine now. Her describing a story of how she found out about that shit was scary. Wrecked her car and everything. Still hadn't heard nothing about it. Now, I talked to my father around Christmas. All right. We talked. Was all good talking to Pops, and that was it. Well, I find out from my sister, well, we lost 3 family members around Christmas. Now, you know how it goes in the black family. Everybody's an uncle or auntie, and they might not be blood at all. They've just been hanging around the family forever. So I'm still trying to figure out, were these people actually blood, or were they just affiliated, right? 3 of them. 2 uncles, 1 aunt. One of which my father found in his house dead. I ain't heard shit. This was all around Christmas. I ain't heard a goddamn thing. Now, the reason I say that this could just be me is because my mother raised me away from those. My father's side of the family. She raised me away from them. She know all of them. She raised me away from them. She didn't want me to get into the same shit that they were getting into, apparently. Right? Think of it as like, oh, the girl on the hill got involved with the dude on the wrong side of the tracks and nobody liked him because they just poked up niggas and we affluent and smart people. You get the picture. You got family, you get the goddamn picture, right? So the mentality that's been cultivated with some of them is that I don't care about them. They love me to death. And I say them being my father's side of the family, my cousin's stuff, they love me to death. I love them. We don't talk all the time. They don't see me all the time. So when stuff is going on like that, they don't reach out to tell me. They all got my number. I don't change my number. My mother worked for the phone company for mother, grandmother, uncle, everybody worked for the fucking phone company, be it Pacific Bell or AT&T for more than 30 goddamn years. We understand, don't change your number. Your number will be the same forever. They all got my number. It don't change. Motherfuckers don't call for shit. Unless need something or some drama. Then I'll hear about it. And if you know me, I don't like hearing about drama if that's the only time I hear from you ass. Don't. Now, here it is. I got three family members slabbed up and a sister that could have been slabbed up, and nobody bothered to tell me shit. Didn't think to mention it at all. But if they needed a door fixed, I'd have got that call. So I kind of expressed it to my sister and went on her, and I made her cry, but that's like, that's neither here nor there for me. At times I make people cry. Call it a talent, call it a skill, I don't fucking know. I don't have that sympathy in that sense for it, but it happens. Okay, I understand people cry and they hurt. Or they feel hurt. I don't like seeing it because I'm not going to engage in it with you. And kind of can't be sympathetic. I was not acculturated like that. Crying meant you got it worse because you were weak. So, yeah. I understand people do it, but does not deter the message. So my sister cried. Well, I let up on her a little bit and let her know that I'm only upset because I love her. I don't want to be finding out shit like that after fact, because we're only getting older. I'm in my 40s. My sister is in my 40s. And we need to be close, regardless. And one of the reasons why I'm happy that my children are so close, even with different mothers, is because I instilled that in them, that I didn't give a fuck who their mother came from. They're both part of me. And us adults ain't gonna be here forever. So they need to be as tight as they can, because they're gonna need each other when all this adult shit is gone. They're gonna have to have each other. And thankfully, my children are close. They're close. So that was something that, something I thought was a problem in my upbringing that I tried to make sure I fixed with my children, because I didn't get to see my sister that often. I love the hell out of my sister. I do. And she's been through a lot of stuff, a lot of bullshit in life she didn't have to go through if I was there. She wouldn't have to go through that shit. So I say all that to not for sympathy, just to share with you guys some of the other stuff that's going on outside in the background of work, the shop, YouTube, fucking politics. There's still life being lived that you can actually be a part of and actually have some control over. And actually, to echo Dr. Tiasan's point, is that you need to check on your folks, especially your brothers, but you need to check on your folks during times like this. Because a lot of shit can fall by the wayside. That relative that died in his house and my father was the one who found him, I don't know if anybody knew he was there outside of my pop, because my pop will go and check on folks just because. So there are methods and reasons for the madness, and one of the things I do support is brothers looking out for each other. That's why I don't like to see a lot of dumbass division. Too much other shit going on to be fighting each other over shit that we don't control. Yeah, it ain't about us. So, as a little pick-me-up, I think we need a little pick-me-up. I do. Sincerely do. Yeah, I don't want that up there. But I want the sound. Okay, I guess that works.
Get your booty to the pole, 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 yeah.
Did we get your attention? Good. So.
Get your booty to the pole, 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 yeah.
Did we get your attention? Good. So.
Hopefully y'all heard that. Otherwise, I just feel stupid sitting up here listening to it myself. Could y'all hear that? I'm trying to figure out if this thing is working correctly, and I don't know. I like it too much, Artie, more because it's funny. It's funny as hell. I still need to work on making the clip of that just so I can keep the part that I want. All I want is the music in that first part. Did we get your attention? Good. That's it. That's all I need. I just need the 30 seconds. The rest of that shit is whatever. I'm not even looking at the video. I'm just listening to the music. All right? So. This life. Let me go back from here before I do anything else. Anyway. So, we're about at 3 hours. I think I've divulged enough of my shit. I brought y'all down into a low place, and I need to go back up. I can't leave y'all in a low place. So, let's talk about some shit. Some actual geek shit that I actually like. Done the comic shop stuff. I will drop this GoFundMe link in there again. Feel so inclined. Definitely support it. It goes to me renovating and finishing out the buy for the shop. It will be, copy the link down, check back on it tomorrow. It should be up tomorrow and open for all of you guys to do what you want to do. I'm probably going to run it for 30, 35 days. It'll probably take, I can't remember how long they told me it would take for me to do my transfer. It was like a week or two for me to do my transfer funds over. And then I should be able to sign the paperwork, cut the check, and get the shop before the end of the month. So February would be a good time to start a new business. It would be, oh, fuck, that'd be awesome. If I can get this done in this month, that'd be awesome because that'll be, well, coming up on the 2-year anniversary of me live streaming or starting making content on my channel. Then it'll be Black History Month as well, which can be really fucking cool. I need to really plan this shit out better. This could be a really cool moment in time. Really transformational. Artisan back to what he was saying about comics and sexual content in comics. I honestly think dark comics should have ratings like video games. They do. Dr. Spawn. They do in a way. Like some comics, like say, take DC's Black Label comics. Those are mature comics. They know that. That's why you got the Batwing in it. Right? Marvel used to have Marvel Max. They were mature comics. But what happens is when you put stuff like that out there, it becomes what people want to see normalized. So they keep skirting close to the line. Like, Black Label stuff is cool, so you know what it is. There is some maturity ratings on some comics, which it should be for some content. But I don't believe a mature rating is necessary just because somebody is gay or whatnot in the book. That doesn't need a mature rating, does it? Is the whole book about them being gay or something like that? I don't know. Could be this fucking story. But it happens, right? I don't have a problem with people being gay. It happens. I just don't like it pushed the way it is on other people, and that they're made to feel or supposed to feel ashamed for not being, or saying, well, I don't necessarily agree with that. That's not okay. That's what I don't get. I don't like them actually trying to turn every character into somehow a pansexual or gay, homosexual, some kind of character. That's unnecessary. You can make up a new character and introduce them, but they don't want to do that. They want to take established characters and twist them in that way. I don't agree with that, because that's not the intent of what the person who created this character had. That goes against the people who are creating the characters. Now, you can argue that and get into that, the fact that, well, these companies own these characters so they can do what they want with them. Yes. When KK was in charge of Lucasfilm, she did what she wanted to with that shit. You saw how the fans reacted to it too, didn't you? Was that what George Lucas wanted? I'm not for shitting on the creator of anything. Be it the creator of comic book characters, or creator of all this universe and all that shit, or parents who create their children. I'm not for shitting on the creators. Not. Doesn't work for me. But I am in support of you creating your own shit with those kind of stories. I am. I might even support it. Because I am for people having their voice to express what they want. But I'm not in favor of them trying to express what they want with other people's shit and changing it from what it was so they can express their points. That's theft. And that's not creative. And it's not yours. So, there should be a law that there should have an M rating only. Comics. There are some comics that are like that have ratings, but that's what the whole comics code was supposed to be about. It was something that the industry did to try to keep, you know, government in a sense out, but they can print without that shit whenever they feel like it, and it can be manipulated whenever they feel like it, and say, well, your content needs to be kind of, you need a more mature rating because you got, you know, characters on the cover that might engage in sex. Those of us old enough remember that. I was just at storage. I'm supposed to go to storage today. I should pull out that book and take a picture of it for you guys, especially for Arnie Inmore, just to show it to you. But I got to throw some stuff away in storage and put some stuff in, because I will be moving. So where are we at? I really didn't feel like hearing anybody else talk today. I want to keep this short and get in and get out and get done what I needed to. I have some things I need to do and some people I need to see. And yeah, I think I'm gonna end this now. I have 2 hours. Appreciate you guys for coming through. Thank you to everybody who supported the channel. I do appreciate it. Like I said, the channel doesn't run on hopes and dreams. These streams run on green. This shit costs money. So I appreciate you guys for coming through and supporting that shit and listening to my, oh, I forgot one. Shout out to Spain. Thank you for the Cash App. Appreciate that. Arda Idmore, you're trying to make me sound like a hypocrite, huh? Because nothing wrong with a swimsuit issue. I always like seeing an X-Men swimsuit issue for some reason. Because X-Men, well, here's the thing. There's a funny thing on that. Swimsuit issues. Who did the best swimsuit issues, Arda Idmore? Jim Lee. Jim Lee always did good swimsuit issues. That was his ass. Because Jim Lee could draw women. And if you never picked up a pen and tried to draw some shit, drawing women is hard. That's a, to me, that's like a special fucking skill. Like that dude, Manara, I think his name is. The painter, the Italian painter. He paint. I can't paint for shit. That motherfucker paint women that look beautiful. He got a Psylocke picture and a Storm picture that looks beautiful. Oh. Like that shit. Like that shit. So swimsuit issues. Yeah, Jim Lee did some good ones. He did some for the X-Men, and he did them for Wildcats and the Wildstorm characters. He did. He does good issues. I mean, I don't know why people was buying Fathoms outside of Michael Turner drawing the women. Michael Turner can draw. I mean, it's hard, dude. If you can do that shit well, that's a skill. Because I'd stopped drawing other stuff just to work on drawing women for a long time. I think the horror sci-fi comic should be banned. Nah, Dr. Spawn, I'm not riding with you on that. I don't ban people for wanting to put out their own stuff. I don't like them changing established characters to do it. That's my whole point. This social justice warrior, homosexual stuff, horror, sci-fi, they can still make all that stuff. It doesn't need to be banned. They just need to make their own books of that shit. They don't need to try to feed it into every other book to try to get people to accept it. That's not acceptance at that point. That's subversion. If you say, this is my book and it's about, and this is what it's about, and it has social justice warrior and stuff in it, I might read it. But if you take that shit and stuff it in the fucking Black Panther or something like that, I'm going to look at you and say, what the hell are you doing? Black Panther, this ain't Black Panther. No, but this is what you should understand. Nah, bruh. Nah. This is not it. Yeah, J. Scott Campbell. J. Scott Campbell could draw the hell out of some chicks. And they'd get on Bulbas and stuff. That's why I say drawing chicks, Arda Idmore, drawing females is a special skill to me in art. It is. Because it's like drawing mechanical. Everybody who can draw a square can't draw mechanical stuff. Cannot draw mechanical. Right? I think drafting. I can draft. I've taken drafting. I can draft and draw blueprints and stuff like that. But I cannot draw mechanical stuff. Can, but it doesn't look right to me. Right? If you take somebody like Pat Lee, I'm sure you know who Pat Lee is. Arda Idmore. Pat Lee from Dreamwave. That dude looked like he was born to draw mechanical. And I'll show you right now. There we go. Even better. Even better. Before we get about this piece. What the hell? Wrong picture. There's a wrong picture. What the fuck? Oh my God. There it is. That's the wrong one. Stop. I wish I could screen. I haven't figured out how to screen share multiple pictures at the same time, which will be helpful. Uh, All right, so this is Pat Lee drawing Dreamwave Comics drawing Transformers. This is all hand-drawn. Hand-drawn. This motherfucker can draw. Not just draw. He can draw mechanical, which is difficult. That's a whole different art style. If you can draw mechanical, you can do architectural work, drafting and stuff like that. It's a different skill. It's not like drawing manga. Drawing manga is its own separate thing, and I think Dead Set Anime has talked about it, how you want people to draw, but not people who can just draw manga, because it's more stripped down art style. It's not all this detail and stuff. And Pat Lee could draw mechanical. Now, at the same time, same time, you look at something like this. Pretty sure that's Aspen. That's Michael Turner drawing a female. Look at the lines on that shit. Smooth, curving lines. It's not a rigid line anywhere in there, except maybe on her backhand and her fingers and her hair. Drawing hair is hard as fuck. Especially if you don't have long flowing hair. You have to learn how to do that shit. You have to learn how to draw that stuff. How to draw eyes softer. How to draw muscle definition and stuff like that softer for women. You have to learn how to do that shit. That is not fucking easy work. And dudes like this, who stand out, is because they do it so well. They do it better than most people. All right, let's just say, which one am I going to use? I'll just use this one. This one will work. This will prove a point. Like, take this one. Now, everybody knows who this artist is, and I don't give a damn about the color of the character at this point. It's not about the color of the character, all right? Yeah, you got to use some tools for that. You got to use rules and curves. I have my curves and stuff like that, but I freehand everything. For the most part, I freehand stuff. The expression on her face, just drawing the lips is tough. Just drawing a believable nose is tough. Just drawing the eyes is another skill. You might have drawn 100 dude eyes. You might have drawn dudes with masks and all kind of stuff and all this shit with the little thin eyes and all the rest of that shit. Going back and putting light and hand drawing light into some life, into the eyes of somebody when you draw with a pencil on some shit is tough. I would think it's tougher in a digital medium. Because you don't have the ability to just use a tool to make a circle. You have to draw that circle. It's all your hand. Right? That's a skill. That's a separate freaking skill. And if you take that from J. Scott Campbell, who that was. And what is that? Oh, he did a Spawn picture? That motherfucker. What's the other picture I was looking at? There we go, this one. If I get two screens, y'all gonna hate me. If I get two screens, y'all gonna hate me. Now you look at that, and you see the difference between his guys and his girls. Between his female characters and his male characters. Some of the same stuff is there, but he knows how to draw them. He knows how to draw proportions. It's a different freaking skill. And he did all those pictures. All those characters on that screen. Oh, Art of Immortal, don't even get me started on David Finch. Let's just do this for the Doughboy so we don't have a problem. We had no problems. David Finch do some badass Batman, that's for sure. There we go. Now this would actually be a good comparison to what you saw with J. Scott Campbell and Michael Turner. Oh, damn, this is distorted as fuck. Not that one, man. Go this one. There we go. That'll work. That will work. There, that's David Finch. You can do that Art of Immortal. You know when you got to do it. Sunday. Or during a week late, which you're usually at work. Yeah, this is David Finch. This is a good, this is one of my favorite pictures of Wonder Woman, actually. But even though I don't like her scared little girl look in her face on this one, and her legs look a little bit too bulky around the knee, it looks like guy's knees, this is actually a good picture. I do like the hair. I do like the hair on it. Because I can't, look, I have a hard time drawing things to make them look imperfect. I do. I'm really rigid in how I draw things. But that goes to my personality. Like the sword, I can draw this sword all day. This flowing hair and making it all come together as one mass. Okay, I have a tough time. I have a tough time. So, that's what it is. I'll do Frank Cho and then I'm going to get out of here because there are some things I need to do before it gets much later. Frank Cho. Find a good picture. Okay. Now, see, this is the thing. I don't think the Asian artists get as much shit as Americans do about drawing females. Because they're not growing up in that country. A lot of Asian artists can really draw women. And I attribute it to them being fucking geeks and idolizing women, in a sense. Now, this is a Frank Cho drawing. That doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bad at all. But it's a non-threatening pose. You can actually see your fucking toes and shit. It looks like he did it in the computer, though, because all his outlines are really hard. Really hard, dark outlines. But no, that looks pretty awesome. That looks pretty awesome. Look, we got into actual geek stuff, and the numbers kept dropping. Motherfuckers just love the drama. Love the drama. Anyway. I gave a fuck. Oopsie. Wasn't ready for that yet. So, anyway, Frank Cho uses micro pens. And Yokito Kushiro, yes. Battle Angel, yes. Those are some amazing drawings. That's why I like some of the anime artists or the manga artists better when it comes to women, because they do focus on it and they take it in a different direction. It's not like it's like steampunk sexy or something like that, or cyber sexy. It's weird. It's a weird thing which makes it look artistic and feminine and sexual all at the same time, which is really, really weird. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. I'm at 3:11. Thank you guys for showing up. Thank you for donating. Thank you for coming through and listening to my rant. Thank you for tolerating I know I'm going to hear about this shit later on somewhere. But thank you for suffering the fools. And I will, in some senses, see you guys next time. So peace.
One love to Long Island, hip stay in my heart, baby. Shall and what? Dribble.
Dangerous ground. 3 pounds, 7 spin around for my brethren. The clouds come down. War and peace. I take it to the street. Land sharp on my lawn. Chop the thumbs off a leaf. And curse his firstborn. Is this thing on? Send them to the children of the corn. We the people. See, thinking through the eye of the needle. My lethal injection. Destroy evil. Hot nickel. Private eye. One pistol. And your brain tissue, do or die. Set the spider to the fly. Goodness, one be tasty like mama apple pie. Goodness, Johnny Lace me on the job of Dick Tracy. Get the cure for that ill shit like Big Casey. MD, symbolic from the cottage shocking. Like a finger in a light socket. Too good to be forgotten. In the rotten apple, I kick dirt on your sandcastle. Check the flavor, all natural.
Beat your feet,
my dick's up,
eat wiser. Before you get the
red cord,
taste an apple cider.
Submerge in the world, heavy-handed verbal, smack you. Mentally disturb you, attack you. 36 chain, once again, coming at you. Young gun got the body snatch you, observe. Wise words you can only see through the third. I form way beyond the norm on the birth. Shine on, mental nourishment, you can dine on. Track yelling at me, get your rhyme on, y'all. Hit the biggest hall, regardless to whom or what. The door moving tall, it's a law. Running through your house and your block party with rap shoddy and hot rock the body. Saint Bernard couldn't save your entourage. Rap lobotomy, leave your mentally scarred, numb, and possibly dumb, deaf, and blind. Is it? I keep the spine out the battery back, fuck it with mine.
Everybody can throw your hands in the fuck, peace. Ooh.
Mind attack mind. I peel on the starting line. D-Space 9. Designed for knuckleheads who bust guns and no signs. Let's converse. NASA's half a members. Body surf on the birds head first. Beat your feet. Big street. Beat you down with the heat. Keep your spats down. Spitting out tea. Ain't nothing big. Big boys. Don't destroy. Blunt and soul. Pump steroid. 50 man convoy. Spencer wears the big toy. Rumble through the wasteland. Right hands on the silencer. 40 caliber. City slicker. Staten Islander. Synchronized minds. Combined doors. That motivate. Don't perpetrate. Pass the blunt. Let it circulate. Street politicians on a suicide mission. Crime vision. Finger itching from a scope view position. Dangerous ground. Trade pounds. Seven spin around for my veteran. The cloud comes down.
Keep your eyes open. Love potion number nine. Poetry in motion. Knowledge me the seven signs. Scope and conniving. Infiltrators both the mind. Play them nonchalantly. Calmly expose the nine. Push it, get shoved. What the fuck? Cuz thinking up. Coming in the club with that screw face. Acting up. As we men the mice. Bad moon rise and we wild for the night. Killer schizophrenic nigga twice. Cuz oh, that's what happened. We're fronting on the shout, bro. I'll in the stat and we in here. No fear. Assault with intent. To kill your whole regiment. It's red. Starting with your president. Ducking my dark gun. Tear apart, son. You don't want it, then don't start none. Blaze one with Jonathan. Part man, part fly. Handle my B.I. Camouflage like G.I. Fat like Joe. A day in the life. Your money or your life. That's the life. Everybody can't afford ice in the struggle. Trying to eat right. Another day, another hustle. 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 Dangerous ground. Trade pound seven's been around for my brethren. The clouds come down. War and peace. I take it to the street. Land sharp on my lawn. Chop the thumbs off a thief. Motherfucker.
Product of this shit, homie, you know, shit.
All day.
When y'all got it popping up there, shit. Basically, down here in Dago, we got it popping too, you know?
Go ahead.
Didn't pick this occupation, it came with the environment. A sweatshop out on my block. No way to acquire retirement, gentrification in the way. Vertically integrating me and Nip with politic on this exact situation. Painstaking events that will equal a rep. Park boy flagging through the halls of the Lincoln Prep. Politically incorrect, why I'm known for the set. Frontline Huffman's at lunchtime, outfit color the Jets. Pillar and the community, no chance for immunity. Successful crack men I saw in the 80s ruin me. Gang politics complicated as Kobe going. Our icons bygone just right before they wings was gold. Choices, what does that word mean? When you pop on a team high school and a gang when you hang wear green. One of the fellas before you even knew it. Socked on by some older kids for wearing blue kicks. Lying to mom say they hurt my feet. And the only ones that's comfy is the green Chuck T. By 13, I'm a LPB. Only challenge Southeast before schools use the term bully. Just think if we'd have got punched on for getting bad grades instead of getting punched on for turning down fades. Could have been a criminal lawyer with all he know about the system. Had straight eyes. The big homie said he could squabble and list them.
Growing up in the hood, I'm a G. Took a couple fades in the middle of the street. What the hell have we? Don't stand what you stand for. Niggas are scared of scrap. Stand what you stand for. Listen. It used to be on and poppin'. Now they got too many real niggas droppin'. What the hell happened? You don't stand what you stand for. These niggas done turned fast. You stand what you stand for. Tellin' on they daily sons. No honor where they come from. But we gon' keep it 100. We don't stand what you stand for. The real key wears the rules and we own the show me the money. I need the money. Show me the money. I need the money. We get the money. I need a bag, show me the money. I need a bag, me and my niggas.
Started off young in the neighborhood. Moms tried to show me how to stay good. Took me under mainland of the drug sales. Wrong colors plot little females. Introduced to the pot of blue color. Watch sales in the undercover brothers. Kid dreams, daydreaming with the fiends. Now it's colors in the hood, we rep it by any means. Could have been straight with a sport. Every 3 weeks, nigga, in and out of court. Trapped in a trap, nigga, no doubt. Kinda funny how they tryna push a nigga out.
Your ass up.
Low come in the projects. Now it's colorblind rules, nigga, what's next? Take dicks, tied with the bat around. Goose file strap, nigga, probably jam. same color as the sky in the high school. Fuck them other niggas, don't try. Yeah, look, that's the first rule. Keep your composure, kind of cool. Yeah, nice with the tool. You get caught slipping, motherfucker, you a fool. You a fool, though. I said, yeah, that's the first rule. Keep your composure, low.
Turn up in the hood, I'm a G. Took a couple fades in the middle of the street. What the hell have you? Stand what you stand for. Niggas scared to scrap. Stand what you stand for. Shit used to be on and popping. Now they got too many real niggas dropping. What the hell have you? Stand what you stand for. Niggas the turn faggot. Stand what you stand for. Telling them they listen. No, I don't know where they come from. But we gon' keep it 100. We don't stand what you stand for. The real key wears the rules. And we own one. Show me the money. Yeah. I need the money. Yeah. Show me the money. Yeah. I need the money. Yeah. We getting money. I need a bag. Show me the money. I need a bag. Me and my niggas.
Yeah. Pop and that's Blue Stamp Official. Try it for him on the beat. Beat him down, low. Original. You get it? We don't give a fuck what you niggas gonna do. You heard that? Shit.